It is finally Friday, and that means one thing, Friday Night Lights for the Lakin Bronx football team. Brett and Sandy Hendricks welcome you to LakinSports.com and Lakin Bronx Sports on YouTube for live coverage of Lakin Bronx football. All of the football action is brought to you by the KCB Bank of Lakin and Garden City, the agency of Lakin and Garden City, your full-line insurance agency, Lakin Hay and the Lakin Dairy, Fred Ripsema, Shelter Insurance, Gwen Wechter, East Highway 50, Lakin, Fleischbach's Diner, West Highway 50, Lakin, the Golden Plains Credit Union, Life with a Touch of Gold, the Lakin Recreation Commission, Lakin Drug, 610 O'Laughlin, Lakin, Shorty's Cafe, Main Street, Lakin, the Kearney County Economic Development, Ralph Goodnight, Pioneer Communications of Southwest Kansas, Hendricks Welding, Brad Hendricks, and Debock Metals of Lakin, Player of the Game, medal sponsor. It is time now to head to the press box with the longtime voice of the Lakin Bronx, Brett Hendricks, along with Jared Hendricks. Take it away, gentlemen.
And a good Friday evening. Welcome to Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube. Brett Hendricks with you. I'll be later joined by Jared Hendricks on the sideline for us tonight. But tonight is homecoming at Lakin High School. The Bronx return home after a disappointing loss at Goodland last week, and they return home to battle the Cimarron Blue Jays in action here tonight. A lot of things going on. We're not going to waste any time. We're going to get into our pregame. Your pregame sponsor tonight, the agency of Lakin and Garden City.
Some commercials make it really tempting to buy cheap insurance. That's great if price is the only thing that's important to you. The agency believes cost is important, but protection is what you're really paying for. Rely on the agency to build the policy that protects your property at a price you can afford. Call the agency today at 620-355-6789.
Our Lakin coaches interview, we had a chance to talk to Coach Bamberger here earlier. Our coaches interview brought to you by the Lakin Rec Commission.
The Lakin Recreation Commission has a full fitness room with 5 treadmills, tread climber, rolling machine, 3 elliptical fitness cross trainers, 2 stationary bikes, and strength training fitness equipment. You'll find just what you need for your own quality workout. The fitness room is open for the public's use free of charge during business hours. For use after business hours, Lakin Rec also has a keyless entry system available. The Lakin Rec Commission, always involved with the youth of Lakin, 702 North Campbell, Lakin, 355-7039. The benefits are endless.
And welcome back to Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube. Brett Hendricks with you. Thanks for joining us tonight for Bronx football. Bronx are back home for homecoming as they get set to battle the Cimarron Blue Jays. And we're now joined by Bronx head coach Chris Bamberger. And coach, last week, a disappointing loss. The Bronx now 2-1, no doubt about it, just a disappointing loss last week at Goodland.
Yeah, you know, we talked about it before. We've talked about it a little bit through the weekend, and it was a good football game. As a spectator, you know, you like to watch good football games, and it's tough to feel good about the football game when you lose. Obviously, there's a lot of opportunities for growth and a lot of things to learn from, and sometimes you don't feel those things as much when you win. So hopefully it gave us some things to build on, and it gave us a mentality that, you know, we got a lot of things to work on, and, you know, hopefully we'll come out and grow from it.
Normally, I start off with the offense that we talk about then, but tonight I'm going to start with the defense because I thought last week the defense held Goodland to 16 points, but I really thought they did a good job against Lincoln Keir, their 6'6 receiver. He did torch the Bronx for a long touchdown pass, but, I mean, in the grand scheme of things, I thought the defense really played him really well.
Yeah, a kid like that in any matchup, we're going to see a similar kid, different skill set and different position, not built the same. But kids like that, really good football players, really good athletes, they get plays. They make plays. That's just the case. You know, they always have their opportunities and take advantage of them. The key is to minimize them and to minimize the big plays. And so we felt like, with the exception of one, we did minimize the big play. He hurt us in a couple areas, but it was things that are like, okay, we can stop the bleeding there and we can continue to play. And we were definitely pleased with how we did handle him throughout the game.
and throughout the game, the defense, I thought, did a good job of getting the ball back to the offense, and that's where we're going next. Offensively, the offense spent a lot of time in Goodland territory, but just didn't take care of didn't take advantage of the opportunities.
Yeah, and I think when you go back and watch the tape, we saw a lot of missed opportunities. We saw a lot of areas where we were just miss some execution here, they would do something a little bit different to us and it would mess us up. And that's the growing pains that we're going through right now. Obviously, those are issues that, you know, you have them with any football team, especially early in the year. There's things that we mess up from time to time, and they hurt us a little bit more. Obviously, a pretty well-matched, even-matched football game, and you've got to really minimize those things to win a football game.
Of course, Lakin is a strong running football team. Last week, it just seemed like every yard that was gained, they earned every yard of it. Goodland, their front line did a good job of containing the run, but was able to mix some passing in last week. Maddox, the long touchdown pass to Ross Ryder. But that's one thing about it, you know, they always say running sets up the pass. Pass can also set up the run as well. So I think with that pass play, Lakin made the defense respect the two-headed monster, so to speak. But I thought the mixture of plays last week was pretty good. Just have to just cash in on some of them. That born anything.
Yep, that's exactly right. It's the opportunities when they present themselves. We got to be ready to take them. And in a tight ball game, they're sometimes few. You know, the opportunities are sometimes few, and it seems like the teams that cash in on them usually the ones that finish with the win.
And sadly, that's what we saw last week at the end of the ball game. This week is homecoming week. Always a favorite thing for a coach to talk about, and it doesn't matter if it's football, basketball. It wouldn't matter if it's tiddlywinks. It seems to be sometimes a distraction. How has the week gone with all of the events and all of the things going on?
Well, you know what? I try really hard as a coach to let the kids be kids.
Yep.
Ultimately, we have a lot of people that put a lot of work and effort in Stucco and cheer and band and all the people that are involved in the festivities of homecoming. They put a lot of work into that, and our boys do enjoy those opportunities to be social and get out there and be kids. So all in all, it was a really neat week for the kids. But, you know, the message that we always echo, I think is probably common in any program, is don't forget about Friday night, right?
Yep.
That you know, it's a good way to put a cap on a really neat homecoming week. And the homecoming week feels a lot better, you know, if you can finish with a win. And so, you know, when you're dealing with 14 through 18-year-olds, you never know, right? But
yep.
I feel like our kids have came with a good mentality, and hopefully, you know, time will tell us again when we kick the ball off if we're ready to play and if we're ready to take advantage of the opportunity.
I don't think it's ever a distraction game night, but I do think maybe sometimes preparation, maybe their mind's not always there. But it's one of those deals, as the Bronx come out on the field tonight, as soon as you enter that tunnel, the week is over. And those kids are really, they're ready to play football. There's no doubt about it. They're not sitting there thinking about the homecoming king and queen. They're not thinking about the dance tomorrow. They're thinking we're running out of this tunnel. We're playing the Cimarron Blue Jays. So,
right.
You know, it is a culmination, like you said. And there's no doubt that they're ready to answer the bell.
Yeah, we hope so. And you know, you look at a football season and there's just not a lot of games anyways, right?
Yeah.
You're talking about 9 games a season that are guaranteed. And so, you know, I think, you know, they have to come with a mentality of like, okay, we don't have very many of these. And heck, you know, we're already about mid-season
almost.
Anyways. And so,
yeah.
You know, the opportunities are going, they're flying, you know, it's going. And so hopefully that they treat it as such.
A year ago, Lakin snapped an 8-game losing streak to Cimarron with an exciting 2-0 victory. You know, I had so many people ask me after that game, did Cimarron forfeit? They saw the 2-0 score, but I guess if a person likes defense, that's what it was last week. But all joking aside, though, but a win's a win. But tonight, it's time for the Bronx to start a winning streak of their own. Let's go out and get this 2 in a row tonight, Coach.
You know, I ran into a couple of the seniors from last year, and that's what they said. They said, hey, guys, let's continue now. Hey, we got over the hump on the streak for Cimarron, and let's continue now. And you know, I've had a lot of kids, man, Coach, you want to win by more than 2 points this year? I said, guys, I don't care if we can finish the game with more points. I will celebrate just the same as any kind of win. So it makes no difference to me if we play hard, we play clean, and we finish the game with more points.
There are never no there's no style points for a W. You take it no matter how it looks. So yep. Looking forward to it tonight, Coach. It's going to be a beautiful evening for football. No wind at all. As soon as the sun goes down, it's going to cool off into a beautiful night. As always, thanks for taking the time to come talk to us. Always appreciate it. And good luck tonight. We look forward to talking to you afterwards.
Thanks, Brett. We appreciate you.
You betcha. Thanks, Coach. That's Bronc head coach Chris Bamberg once again. The Bronx gets set to battle Cimarron tonight in the homecoming game. The Bronx 19-23 all time against the Blue Jays, looking to add to that total tonight. When we come back, we'll continue with our pregame right here on Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube.
It's time to get involved with the Lakin Recreation Commission, 702 North Campbell in Lakin. The Lakin Rec Commission with a wellness center, aerobics, adult programs, youth programs, sewing, and more. For more information about all the great activities of the Lakin Rec Commission, call 620-355-7039. The Lakin Recreation Commission, providing recreational opportunities to enhance the quality of life for the people of the community by promoting social interaction and the productive use of leisure time.
Our league outlook, we're going to try to run it through it as quick as we can, but our league outlook brought to you by Pioneer Communications. On the track right now, Scott and Tanner Harris are being honored. For Tanner, one of the big Bronc fans, and Scott, a 1975 graduate of Lakin High School, being honored on the track at this time before we get things started with our homecoming festivities. Our league outlook brought to you by Pioneer Communications.
They said this place was too isolated to call home. They said it was too remote to build a community. And then one day, a farmer strung a copper wire from one fence post to another and changed everything. We didn't build the communities of Southwest Kansas. No, we just brought them together.
Thank you to Scott and Tanner Harris. Like I said, Tanner, one of the big fans for Lakin High School sports. And I'll tell you what, we're just going to, I think they're going to go right into the homecoming festivities. So we're going to do that as well. We're going to alter our pregame that we can get the homecoming festivities in. So I'm just going to shut up and put my microphone to the PA announcer and enjoy the homecoming festivities.
Favorite color is purple, and his favorite thing to do is ride bikes and play with the Smith Street Gang. Dax is the son of Chris and Lacey Bamberg. A couple of things to know about Aiden. His favorite color is blue. His favorite activity is playing outside. Aiden being escorted by Maddox Beltran, his son of Thomas and Joey Beltran.
So congratulations to Kinsey Lumen Fuller and Maddox Beltran, your 2023 football homecoming king and queen. Once again, congratulations, Kinsey Lohman Fuller and Maddox Beltran, the 2023 football homecoming king and queen. So we're going to continue with our pregame. Take a look at what's going on around the High Plains League. Scores from last week: Southwestern Heights defeated Syracuse 44-28. Ellenwood defeated Stanton County 24-6. And in a game you saw right here on Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube, Goodland down the Lake and Bronx 16-14. In eight-man games, Wichita County, the defending eight-man Division I state champions, defeated Hoxie by the score of 48-14. Sublette beat Buckland 26-24. And Elkhart bested Springfield, Colorado by the score of 34-28. Week four game, Southwestern Heights 1-2. They are at 3-0 Hoisington. Ellis 0-3. They travel to Stanton County to battle the Trojans. Trojans 1-2 on the year. And, of course, our game tonight, the Blue Jays 0-3 and the Bronx 2-1. Eight-man games tonight, a big one at Sublette. Battle of two 3-0 teams, Meade 3-0 and the Larks are 3-0. Elkhart 2-1, they're on the road at Satana. Satana 0-2 and Wichita County. They are 3-0 on the season. They travel to St. John. And St. John is 2-1. Our league outlook brought to you by the fine folks at Pioneer Communications. We're back right after this.
They said this place was too isolated to call home. They said it was too remote to build a community. And then one day, a farmer strung a copper wire from one fence post to another and changed everything. We didn't build the communities of Southwest Kansas. No, we just brought them together.
Lakin Drug brings us what's going on at Lakin High School. We're back after this.
At Lakin Drug, their mission is simple. They strive to provide professional pharmacy services with hometown hospitality. Lakin Drug's experienced staff leads with compassion and utilizes modern technology to fit all of your individual needs. Whether it's prescription medications or over-the-counter products, Lakin Drug has the answer to all of your questions. Lakin Drug at 610 O'Loughlin Street in Lakin is a proud supporter of the community of Lakin and Lakin Schools.
Here's what's going on around Lakin High School this week. And, of course, this past week has been busy with all of the homecoming festivities and all the extra activities. But tonight, the football game brings all of that just about to an end. They'll have the homecoming dance tomorrow night. This past Saturday, the cross-country team traveled to Hugoton. The girls finished in fifth place. The boys finished in sixth. The girls led by Emma Miller's 20th placing. Ivy Davis finished 36th. Luna Vasquez in 42nd. Albie Holmes in 44th. And Shalali Kentner in 46th place. Alex Luce paced the Bronx with a second-place finish. Austin Rissima followed with a fourth-place finish. Zael Bermudez finished 45th. Gabe Cox in 50th. Blake Matthews, 57th, and Eric Munson in 61st place. Tuesday night, the volleyball team traveled to Wichita County for a triangular, and they split their two matches, defeating Sublette and losing to Wichita County. Girls golf on Tuesday was at Satana. Allie Mead was tournament runner-up. She finished second with a new personal best, 88. Maya Brown earned her first varsity medal, finishing in ninth place. Girls golf was in Scott City yesterday, and the only score I heard was Allie Mead finished in sixth place. Some things going on next week and even starting tomorrow. Cross country is at Stanton County. Volleyball, the varsity is at Holcomb. JV is here at Lakin, and C team travels to Ulysses. Monday, JV football goes to Cimarron. Tuesday, volleyball is at Elkhart. Girls golf is at Syracuse on Tuesday, and next Thursday, the cross country team travels to Canyon City, Colorado. This week at Lakin High School, brought to you by Lakin Drug.
At Lakin Drug, their mission is simple. They strive to provide professional pharmacy services with hometown hospitality. Lakin Drug's experienced staff leads with compassion and utilizes modern technology to fit all of your individual needs. Whether it's prescription medications or over-the-counter products, Lakin Drug has the answer to all of your questions. Lakin Drug at 610 O'Loughlin Street in Lakin is a proud supporter of the community of Lakin and Lakin Schools.
Keys to the game and starting lineups brought to you by Fred Ritzma, Lakin Hay, and previously of Lakin Dairy.
Fred Ripsema established the Lakin Dairy in 1997 and is now a leading producer of high-quality milk for human consumption. The Lakin Dairy is proud to be a big part of the Kearney County economy and community. With fantastic, dedicated, and hardworking employees, the Lakin Dairy prospers in the heart of, as Fred calls it, the Midwest Feed Shed. Always supporting the Lakin High School students, the Lakin Dairy, a verified premium operation, is honored to call Kearney County home at lakendairy.com on the internet.
And when I said starting lineups, it might help if I dig them out. I don't have starters for Cimarron, but we will concentrate on the Bronx starters. They're getting set for the Bronx to enter the field here in the next 5 minutes or so. So here's how they start. The Bronx 2-1 on the season. Starting at center, Jayton Hash, he wears number 54. Norian Cantu plays right guard. He is wearing number 52. At left guard, wearing number 65, Jeremy Orpiza. At right tackle, wearing number 72, Eli Bemis. At left tackle, wearing number 58, Timmy Johnson. The wide receivers, wearing number 12, Drew Patterson. And wearing number 2, Javion Granado. Wearing number 15, the fullback, Coulter Oldham. At the slots, wearing number 1 is Ross Ryder, and wearing number 7 is, wearing number 3 is Armando Salcido, and the quarterback wearing number 7 is Maddox Beltran. The coaches for the Bronx, Chris Bamberger, Chris Pollard, Travis Johnson, Wyatt Giroux, and Bryce Simon. Keys to the game tonight, with homecoming, there's been a lot of things going on, but as soon as those boys hit that tunnel, they're ready to play some football. So I think the key right now is to don't be too hyped. Go out there, play your game, let the game come to you. Don't take it to the game, and I think they're going to be just fine. But just let the events of the week pass. A lot of things still going on tonight. There's going to be some fireworks going off, a special player introduction tonight. You're going to be let in by the horses as well. So it's going to be a fun night. And once the sun goes down, it's going to be a beautiful night for football. So, and it's also alumni night here at Lakin, and it's alumni weekend here in Lakin as well. So a lot of things going on. We'll hit on a lot of that as we go through the evening. But our keys to the game and starting lineup brought to you by Fred Ritzma. Our pregame has been brought to you by the agency of Lakin and Garden City.
Some commercials make it really tempting to buy cheap insurance. That's great if price is the only thing that's important to you. The agency believes cost is important, but protection is what you're really paying for. Rely on the agency to build the policy that protects your property at a price you can afford. Call the agency today at 620-355-6789.
Now I kind of ran through that all pretty quick, but now we're waiting for the Bronx to make their way up the sidewalk and hit the tunnel and get out here on the field. But our sideline announcer once again tonight is Jared Hendricks, our color analyst. And Jared, you got me down on the field?
You got me?
Oh, yeah. There we go. Okay. Well, you know, I have to turn the volume up. I turned the computer up instead of your wireless.
Yeah, I said loud and clear, but I didn't hear anything. So.
Okay, well, you can say loud and clear again.
Yeah, loud and clear. We're good.
All right. You've been part of, you know, homecomings down here and things like that, but to me, tonight, there's just a different feel down here tonight in the stadium tonight. There's a lot of things going on. Of course, we already had the King and Queen crowning. You know, the tunnel adds to the entrance, but the horses and the fireworks are going to add a lot to it. To me, I just think there's a different feel in the stadium tonight.
Yeah, I mean, homecoming, you never know. It's usually the biggest crowds and kind of the big game of the year, so it's always a fun one for the kids, and always going to have a week packed full of stuff, so you hope that they don't get hurt doing all those fun activities because you got to be ready to play Friday night.
Yeah, and one of the cool things, too, this year, as with last year as well, is it is alumni weekend, so a lot of alumni are back. hate to admit this, but my younger brother is celebrating his 40th class reunion this week, so you know, it's kind of starting to age me, but heck, you've been out 7, so that's even scarier. I mean, 6, you've been, that's scarier.
6 or 7.
It's six. I wasn't a math major.
Yeah, well, I can't even remember what I ate for breakfast yesterday, so.
Oh, but, yeah, it's a lot of fun with Alumni Weekend and a lot of things going on. There's going to be some fireworks, like I said, during the evening, some post-game fireworks, and now let's just hope it's a Bronc victory. But keys to the game, earlier I just said put the week's activities to rest now. Now it's just time to go out and hit somebody.
Oh, yeah, 100%. I mean, me as a player in high school, well, yeah, once everything was said and done, I mean, you're ready to go. There's no distractions, not anything like that. So I know they're going to come out with a little chip on their shoulder and a little bit of pep in their step. So I think there's no worries at all for the game tonight.
And the Bronx looking to make it 2 straight over the Blue Jays after that exciting 2-0 victory a year ago. So let's hope there's a little bit more offense, at least on the purple side.
Yeah, that should be key number one, is score more than a safety.
But you know what?
That should be our score.
But if you win by a safety, there's no style point, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, win's a win, but I want to see that ball flying through the sky a little bit tonight.
Well, there's fireworks going to be shot off every point that's scored, too. So
yeah, hopefully we're out.
Yeah, we don't want to run out before the finale. But, let's add a lot of excitement to this during the evening.
Yeah, it should be a good run out with everything we got going down at here. The wind's hardly even blowing, so it should make for a cool entrance.
Now, I was looking to see. I think it's Mandy, Megan, and Darcy, I believe, isn't it?
I believe so.
So, that's been cool that they started doing that a few years ago. But, hey, you know what? What a better way to bring the Bronx out with them riding some horses.
Yeah, exactly, 100%.
Yeah, so see Cimarron coming up the step down the steps there, but nothing with the Bronx yet. But
I think they're just shortly behind.
Well, you know what? You always want the visitors to enter first.
Yep, that is true.
They are starting the music, but that's definitely not for the visitors coming up the sidewalk. So, all right, Jared. Well, I appreciate it. Thanks for running the camera for the homecoming festivities.
Yeah, not a problem. She should be up there, so
yep,
we're ready to rock and
I've
roll.
Seen the camera moving, and our camera girl tonight is Allie Mead, and I'll tell you what, she's always done a great job for us. I am not worried whatsoever tonight with Allie running the camera for us.
Negative. So.
All right, Jared. Well, I'll keep your mic live. Just kind of chime in anytime you want to.
Sounds good to me.
You're not hearing the Holcomb game yet on your FM transmitter?
No, I'm not getting anything tonight. Might be kind of boring.
Yeah, you were able to give Holcomb updates last week. I mean, 2 weeks ago, because you had it on your headset.
Yeah, because they're going against Liberal tonight, and I think Liberal's 3-0.
No, Holcomb's at Goodland.
Yeah. I swear I heard Liberal this morning on the radio.
No, they opened the season with Liberal.
Oh, well, I guess I was. Oh, it might have been Garden City. That's who it was, I think.
Garden City's at Hayes. Try again.
Well, then. I'm out of teams then. I don't know who's going against Liberal. Because usually 98-1's only Buffs and Longhorns.
Well, 98-1, well, it could be Dodge City. So it might be Dodge City.
Oh, yeah, maybe Dodge.
Might
too.
Be Dodge Liberal.
Yeah. Hey, three times the charm.
Hey, you know what? Just keep picking them down, and you'll eventually get it, right?
Yeah, I was going to say, there's only so many teams anyways.
Exactly.
I'd get there eventually.
Oh, I know it. Yeah. All right.
And here they come.
Bronx with the walk to the tunnel. And we'll see how it goes here. So there might be another special effect to the entrance too, but I don't know if it got done or not. So we'll see how it works. I think it might. So.
Yeah, we got it done.
The smoke?
Yeah, we got it done.
All right, sounds good. Yep, I see him right there. All right, here we go. Jared, that wasn't too bad.
Not too bad, but it definitely smells down here now.
Smoking everybody out now.
Yeah, I was going to say, no bugs tonight.
Well, you know what? That's what our intentions were tonight, too, get rid of the bugs.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, oh, well. Usually we have a strong wind that just blows it away, right?
Yeah, usually.
All right, we're going to break for the playing of our national anthem. Well, all we've got left to do now is play some football. Our first quarter, a new sponsor here on Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube, Matt Medill, CPA, Main Street, Lakin. For the experience of a large firm with personal attention that only a small firm can provide, see Matt Medill on Main Street, Matt Medill, CPA. And glad to have Matt on board with us here on Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube. Hardly any wind blowing here at all at the stadium.
Yeah, it's a little toasty down here.
You know, I when I walked on the turf yesterday before I was announcing the middle school game, but I went down to get starters off from the coaches. But you can tell it. You step from the concrete to the rubberized track, feel the temperature swing, but you really feel it when you step on the turf.
Oh yeah, 100%. But once that sun goes down, it's gonna be good to go.
Oh yeah, exactly. We need to get to that point where the sun is down, and yeah, it's going to be perfect. So looking for a good one. Going to be a nice night once that sun goes down. Captains are meeting at midfield. Javian Granado, Maddox Beltran, Jeremy Orpiza, and Jayton Hash, the captains for the Bronx. The Bronx going in the all-purple look tonight, purple tops and pants. Cimarron in the white tops and the dark pants. Bronx looking to bounce back after a tough loss last week at Goodland. Once again, tonight is alumni night here at Lakin High School. This is alumni weekend. A lot of events going on around the community tomorrow, and we'll touch on some of those. Cimarron has won the toss, and they have deferred to the second half. So the Bronx will receive and have the football to start this football game. So we're set to go. Bronx and Blue Jays live here on Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube. In our 17th year, bringing you Lakin High School activities on the World Wide Web. I want to send a shout out to J.D. Hamm. Texted us, said everything's looking good. Well, you know what, J.D., it wouldn't be looking good if it wasn't for you, buddy. So hope you're doing okay. And we say it every week. We talk about it all the time. But if it wasn't for J.D. and contacting me 19 years ago. This is our 17th year of Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube, but I've been doing this part of 19 seasons now, and it was all JD that got us started back then. We're set to go. Kicking off for Cimarron is number 4, David Mendez. Back to return for the Bronx, Ross Ryder and Armando Salcido. End over end kick, fielded at the 10-yard line. Ryder takes it right up the middle, was tripped up and rolls forward to the 40, maybe the 44-yard line, but a good return by Ross Ryder, almost taking it to the house.
Michael almost called that one.
Really?
And he said, you know, it'd be really nice having a touchdown right here off the kickoff, and he was almost right.
Well, that's good. You know what? Good start to it, Mike. Almost got it.
Yep, almost got that one.
And I'm already in don't know what I'm doing mode. I didn't even start the clock. So here we go. First and 10 Bronx from their 45-yard line. Salcido in motion. Give is to Oldham up the middle. Steps it out to the right side across the 50. He'll get across to the Cimarron 48-yard line. After a gain of maybe 7 yards. Going to bring up second down and 3. Let's go. Bronx receiver split each side. Drew Patterson to the near side. Beltran under center. Give up the middle to Oldham. There is a flag on the play. He will have enough for the first down, but we'll wait and see what the flag is. Sadly, from that position, usually it's a hold on the interior line, but we'll wait and see. And it's going to be a hold against the Bronx. The referees are mic'd up tonight, and there's a capability that we could put their mic'd up system through our broadcast, but I didn't get to it today. So it'd be something maybe we can try for the next home game. So a 10-yard penalty against the Bronx. That will make it second down and 13 now. So the Bronx backed up into their own territory at their 42-yard line. Fake to Oldham. Maddox with the pitch to Ross Ryder. He's got a blocker out in front. He's across midfield and driven out of bounds at the 40. That will be a pickup of 13 yards, 16 yards, and that'll give the Bronx a first and 10. So the Bronx back in some run territory, first and 10 from the Blue Jay 40-yard line. Tight formation, Maddox under center. Maddox following the first guy through on the left side. He'll get across the 40 to about the 38-yard line. Pick up 2, maybe 3 yards. Looks like he's going to pick up 2 yards. And bring up second down and 8. Just underway, the Bronx and the Blue Jays live here on Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube here in Lakin. Shadows getting longer from the west to the east, but another 15, 20 minutes, the sun will not be an issue. And we've got a flag on the play before the play starts. And it looks like it's going to be an offsides call on Cimarron. So that'll bring up second down and 3 for the Bronx after the 5-yard penalty walked off. Salcedo in motion to give us to Oldham off the right side fighting for the first down. And he needs to get to the 30-yard line for the first and 10. Looks like he's going to
be shy about half.
Looks like about a football shy of a first down. So third and a short one for the Bronx from the Blue Jay, almost 30-yard line. 30 and a half, I guess, if there is such a thing.
Oh, there is now.
Okay, I patent it. Anybody that uses it from here on has to pay me.
Yeah. Good luck with that one.
Oldham off the left side, dragging the pile across the 25. He'll have enough for the first down. So basically what we should have said is third and 18 inches.
I guess if you want to get technical.
Maddox with the pitch, Salcedo with a blocker out in front, cuts inside across the 10, and he's going to score. Armando Salcedo with the touchdown.
Man, we shot off 4 of them right there.
Yeah. And you know what? They weren't as loud as I really thought they might be, but that's okay.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's not loud at all.
Yeah. Try for the two-point conversion. Maddox wrapped up, and it will not count. So with 9:04 to go in our first quarter, your first quarter brought to you by Matt Medill, CPA. Bronx lead at 6-0. I'm trying to remember what the yardage was on that touchdown run by Raimondo.
It was wherever Coulter ended up after the 30 and a half.
That's what I was trying to think. I know he carried,
carried it about 6 or 7 yards, so.
I was trying to think maybe about the 22, 23 yard line, something like that.
I'd go with 23.
Okay.
I think that'd be a good estimate.
Close enough. Now, yeah, if I had you up here, you could go back to the replay.
Well, we don't have to have it completely accurate because we don't got a sports book on it, so we don't got to make sure.
It's a good thing we don't have a sports book on it.
Yeah, it's a good thing because I'd be losing money again.
I'm not going to follow your lead anymore.
No, you followed fine. Yours is free bet. Mine wasn't so much.
Yeah. Back receive for the Blue Jays, number 4, David Mendez. And I think it's number 3, Coulter Dorman. Salcedo with the line drive kick, bouncing along the sideline. Oh, it just spun out of bounds.
That almost got the nice roll.
Almost spun dead right there on the hash mark.
Yep.
But that'll be a illegal procedure penalty on the Bronx. The Blue Jays with the opportunity to take it. Let's see. I think at the 40, 35 or 40. No, they're going to make Lakin re-kick it. So they had an option to take it, but they're going to back Lakin up 5 and let them re-kick. Trace Copper, the other deep man for the Blue Jays. So back the Bronx up 5 yards. They'll attempt it from the NFL kick spot from the 35. High end over end kick. Fielded by the up man, Holden Kite. Kite loose up the far side, and he's going to score. Holden Kite with the kick return. One of the up men took it around the 35-yard line, and he took it to the house.
What is the rule with throwing the ball after you score a touchdown?
You know what? I did not see what he did as far as throwing it, but I mean, if you just drop it, not a big deal. But if you're going to toss it, it could be a delay of game penalty.
That's what I was thinking, but I just had people asking down here if it's a penalty, and I said honestly, couldn't tell you if it's like excessive celebration or what it would be. But
yeah, the try for the extra point, no good, and with 8:52, the Bronx are set to get the ball back. We are tied at 6. Well, it's pretty safe to say we're not going to be 2-0, Jared. Two scores within 15 seconds of each other.
Yeah, we've already broke that little curse, so good to go now.
Yeah, so, the Bronx will get it back. We'll see what they can do with it on their next possession. But that definitely took some of the air out of the excitement here in the stands and on the sideline. Yeah, I don't know exactly. Like I said, if he was to just take that ball and just toss it,
I didn't
know, out
even
of the
really
end zone.
See it. The sun was in my eyes, but people were just asking me. I was like, I didn't even see him throw it.
But, you know, I know a lot of times they just drop it or whatever. Definitely can't spike it, and they're not going to punt it away like Travis Kelce did last week.
Yeah, I was going to say, we can't pull the Kelce.
Yeah, you can't punt it away.
Well, Pat McAfee said that if he keeps doing it, he'll pay all his fines, so you might see punts out now on.
Oh, yeah. Well, Pat McAfee's a punter. He would say that.
Oh, yeah, he loves it.
Mendez to kick for Cimarron. Ryder and Salcedo to return for the Bronx. A short squib kick fielded by the Bronx.
Smart choice there.
And immediately downed. I was trying to see who fielded that punt. I think it might have been Jeremy Orpiza.
I think you might be right.
So first and 10 Bronx from their 30-yard line. And they'll update our score. It is 6-6. 8:48 remaining in our first quarter. Bronx come out, two receivers to the near side. Ryder comes in motion, and with it on the sweep is Colter Oldham. Good block out in front, and a flag that's going to trail the play.
I believe it's going to be a hold.
Great play design that time by the Bronx, but a flag, I think, is going to bring it back.
Yeah, I believe that one was on Drew.
So a 10-yard penalty is going to bring up first and 20 for the Bronx. Even though the Bronx scored on their first possession, they did have a holding penalty that took away a first down. So the Bronx don't want to get that habit started. For every 30 they go forward, they're backing up 10 from the line of scrimmage so far. So,
yeah, not great stats on that one.
So first and 20 for the Bronx. Give up the middle. There is a fumble. Ball. And Cimarron recovered. On their recovery was Alex Schlesinger. And the Blue Jays in great field position from the Bronx 22-yard line. So the Bronx started the scoring, and it's been downhill since then. First and 10 Blue Jays from the Bronx 22-yard line. Blue Jays from the gun, Trace Copper the quarterback. Receiver in motion from the far side. Give is to McCoy Nash. Nash wrapped up in the backfield. He'll suffer a loss on the play. Granado, Eli Beamison on the stop for the Bronx. A loss of about two on the play brings up second down and 12. If you're just joining us, Bronx drew first blood with a touchdown. But on the ensuing kickoff, Cimarron took it to the house to even up the score. Both teams failed on their extra point attempts. Eli Bemis on the wrap-up. On the carry was Trace Copper. Takes it back to just about the original line of scrimmage, just inside of the sticks. We'll call it third and 10 for the Blue Jays. The Blue Jay possession after a Bronx turnover. Third and 10, Copper from the gun. Looking to throw, now flush from the pocket, out to the flat, complete. And the play out of bounds. Pass is complete to Chris Robles. First defender for the Bronx missed the tackle, would have brought up a fourth down. Robles able to fight through it.
Yeah, just got to wrap up.
Now first and goal for the Blue Jays at the Bronx 3-yard line. Blue Jays from the gun. Copper up the middle.
And he's in.
And will score. Blue Jays with the swinging gate. And now we're
Coming to the field goal. I was going to say, I thought I saw a tee.
Yeah, well, there was a tee the last time, but they had that option with it with the swinging gate. And the extra point is blocked by Drew Patterson. So with 6:51 to go in our first quarter, the score now, Cimarron 12 and the Bronx 6. You probably have never seen too much of the swinging gate extra point play, have you, Jared?
Not that I can remember at all.
Lakin back in the late 80s, early 90s, ran it a lot. And I remember it more in the late 80s, where it was a direct snap. And what the center can do with that snap, he can throw it sideways as long as it's backwards.
Yeah.
And Lakin had a couple speedy running backs, and all you had to do is just give them a step, and they were going to score that extra point. That two-point conversion. So sometimes it works. Sometimes the gadget play doesn't work so well at all. But once in a while, I like to see it. I like to see gadget plays once in a while, as long as they don't overdo it.
I say, you want them to go out there and do a ring around the rosy?
No, not really. Only Andy Reid can get away with that.
Ah, okay, gotcha.
When you got the best quarterback in the league, you can do that. And don't you even say it. I know what you're going to say.
Debatable.
Yeah. That's only through three games of a season. He's done it in a seven-year career, so don't even start with it. Short end over end kick. Fielded by the up man.
They must not want to kick it back to Ryder or anyone in that deep.
And actually, that's Timmy Johnson on the return there. So Timmy takes it back to the Bronx 36-yard line where the Bronx have it, first and 10.
Yeah, they must have thought off that first kickoff that they didn't want to kick it deep. Because now all of them are just squibs.
Well, yeah. You know, sometimes something like that scares a team off. You know what, though? Ross is going to get another attempt to return one. So.
Oh, yeah.
Him and Armando.
Just have him run up on it.
First and 10, Bronx. Oldham off the left side. Out across the 45, down to the 40. No, not a 45. Across the 40 to the 43. Bring up second down and 2, gain of 8 on the play. .6:20 to go, first quarter. Blue Jays lead it 12-6. Counter to Ross Ryder. Has it across the 45 to the 47. It's good for a Bronx first down. Got just over 2 yards on the play. First and 10, Bronx. Good crowd packed in here tonight for homecoming. Give this to Oldham. Fought off a couple tackles. Now across the 40, the 30. Can he leg it out? And he's going to be brought down at the 11-yard line. Colder Oldham, shifty running through the line, was able to fight off a couple tackles. And it'll be first and goal for the Bronx. at the 10-yard line. Gain of 43 yards on the play. You could hear the public address announcer, Kevin Thompson. So they're going to set up the sticks. So it's just outside the 10-yard line. So not first and goal. And I'll run our clock down. We're at 5:20. Play clock at 2. Bronx with the timeout. That's their first timeout of the half. 5:09. Well, we're going to back up. 5:11 to go in our opening quarter. First quarter brought to you by Matt Medill, CPA. I know one of our sponsors as well, Shorty's Cafe, Main Street Lakin, got us on the monitors tonight. And they will be open after the ball game for alumni and fans to come out and exchange old stories. So, cool weekend, alumni weekend. The field about shaded, almost there. Another 10 minutes and we're going to be in shade. So can already tell just by a little breeze outside the window, it's a beautiful night for football. Light breeze out of the south. So first and 10 for the Bronx, just outside the Cimarron 10-yard line. So they could actually get a first down. Pitch is to Oldham around the left side, stiff arms. First defender reaches out, but he's going to be just shy of the goal line. And depends on where they put it, he could have a first down for first and goal. I don't know, Jared, are you, you're not at the, no, you're down in front. That's about a, I'm going to say the width of the football stripe. Is.
Yeah, sorry, I'm talking. Okay. Talking business.
Oh, okay. But, yeah, I mean, that's the white stripe of the football is about if they got that first down or not. He's as close as you can be and not score.
Yeah, I'll mosey on down here for the old chain stretch.
Yeah, you won't get there in time. Oh, yeah, now you're going to run.
Probably shouldn't have done that. Have to warm up first.
Oh, my goodness, wow. And it's short.
We are extremely short, just right there.
Oh, I tell you what, that's amazing that it's even short. I mean, to get the first down, that ball's got almost touched the white stripe.
Well, he showed short there. We're replacing it, I guess.
Yeah, well, they have to. Right. They have to bring it on the chains to replace
right on,
it.
So. Yep, right on there.
Yep. So
we're good, half foot. Maybe a foot. That's it.
Second and a foot for the Bronx. I don't have that on my scoreboard here, so
12 just, inches.
Yeah, and I never stopped the clock, so I apologize for that. So we'll run it back up to 450.
You think this is going to be a little Jalen Hurts action here?
No. I mean, I don't mind the quarterback sneak, but I hate that play. That's rugby, not football. So second and goal. Beltran under center.
And he's in.
And he'll keep it.
What's Jason Kelce call it? The old tush push?
Yeah.
Man, had those ones going off real nice. Oh, that one was loud. Well, I kind of picked up another game there for a second.
Did you?
But now it's gone.
No. Well, that's good. We don't want you to hear. We don't want you to hear another game.
And he's in.
Who was that on the carry?
Coulter?
Okay.
I believe. No? Who was it? I don't know. I want to say it was Coulter.
We'll take your word for it. So with the extra point, 4:42 to go in our first quarter, the Bronx have struck back and have taken the 14-12 lead. Brett Hendricks along with our sideline reporter Jared Hendricks, thanks for joining us tonight for Bronx football. I want to thank Levi Perez firing off the fireworks for us tonight. I never have to ask him twice if he wants to fire off the fireworks.
Yeah, that was Coulter that ran in the 2 points.
That was Coulter, okay. Yeah, Levi's done that for us. This is the third year now that we've had him shooting off fireworks.
Yeah, it's very much appreciated because it adds a nice atmosphere.
I love it, yeah. I'll tell you what, I wish I wouldn't get in so much trouble with the public address music. I mean, it's great music. It's great music for the atmosphere, you know. It creates a good atmosphere here.
Yeah.
Heck, I would hang my microphone out the window and just jam out with it. But
yeah, I'd leave mine on, too, but we got to try to talk over as loud as we can.
I know it. Salcido, short end-over-end kick taken by the up man, Peyton Dye. And flags come in at the end of the play. I think there's a holding penalty out in front.
I think that's a hold.
I think there's a hold out in front here.
A hold or an illegal block? I couldn't see it. Coaches got in the way.
Start of the second quarter, Holcomb on top of Goodland, 7-0. Thanks to JD with the update. So a penalty against the Blue Jays. They'll have first and 10 from there. Looks like the 24-yard line. 4:37 to go in our first quarter. Thanks to JD with the update. Copper from the gun. Just the last glimpse of sun in his face, and we've got a flag.
We got a false start.
And a false start on the Blue Jays, so that'll make it first and 15. That'll back them up to the 19-yard line. So the Bronx penalty bug, they've given it to the Blue Jays to start this drive. Two receivers to the left side. Quick pass to Holden Kite. And he's forced out of bounds.
Yeah, off that kickoff, that holding penalty was on Cimarron, and their student section over there was yelling, "You can't do that," and was down here really confused trying to figure out why they were doing that to their own team.
Well, you know, they're right. You can't
do
that.
Yeah, I was going to say, they're just helping them out, letting them know.
Yeah. I apologize, my clock was running. I tell you what, this mouse, I think, is starting to get old. I click and it doesn't seem to start or stop when I want it to, but.
My mouse?
Yeah, for some reason it just has
That's only like a year old.
I know. Yeah, maybe two.
Yeah, you might have to charge it up some more or something.
I don't know, it's been acting kind of slow lately, so. First and 10, Blue Jays. From their 36-yard line. I want to thank everybody for joining us here tonight for Bronx homecoming football with Cimarron. Give is to McCoy Nash. Gets to the 40-yard line, brought down by Jeremy Orpiza and Jayton Hash. Going to gain about 4 yards, brings up second down and 6. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, second and 6. Blue Jays with stacked receivers split to the left side. Copper from the gun. We'll keep it up the middle. Ross Ryder and Maddox Beltran in on the stop. I think he was slowed down by Jeremy Orpiza. But Ryder and Beltran there to finish off the play. Going to bring up third down and 5 for the Blue Jays. And a timeout on the field. Called by Cimarron. That's their first charge timeout of the half. Both teams with 2 remaining. Tomorrow, JV volleyball is here at the Lakin Middle School gym. The varsity is at Holcomb. The C team is at Ulysses. Cross country team is at Stanton County tomorrow. And there is rec football here tomorrow as well. Third and fourth graders start at 9:30. Fifth and sixth grade start at 11 o'clock. And rec football brought to you by one of our great sponsors here on LakenSports.com, Lakin Bronx Sports, Lakin Rec Commission. Shout out to the crew at Shorty's Cafe. Got us on the monitor tonight in the restaurant and the club. So 3rd and 5 for the Blue Jays. Copper from the gun, empty backfield. Rolls to the right end, now picked off by Colter Oldham at midfield, and he's brought down at the Cimarron 43-yard line. Bronx in great starting field position, but good read by Colter from his linebacker spot to step in front of that pass. Actually, they're going to put him at the 44-yard line, 1st and 10 for the Bronx. Ross Ryder with the carry to the near side. He's forced out of bounds at the 30. Couple Blue Jays in around the play there. Logan Seifried and Miguel Ramirez. It's a 1st and 10 Bronx. The Colter Oldham interception gave the Bronx great starting field position on this drive. Field now completely shaded. Oldham off the right side across the 25, carrying a pack of white shirts. He takes them down across the 20 and enough for another Lakin first down. First and 10 from the Blue Jay 19-yard line as the official winds the clock. 1:55 to go in our opening quarter. Bronx on top, 14-12. Brett Hendricks and Jared Hendricks bringing you Bronx football tonight. Thanks for joining us. Give is to Ryder. He'll be brought down for a 1-yard loss. It'll bring up 2nd and 11 for the Bronx at the Cimarron 20-yard line. Like I said earlier, just absolutely no wind blowing here in Lakin. I mean, the flag just barely fluttering. Beautiful night. Give us to Oldham. Bounces it to the outside. Now cuts back into the middle. He'll be across the 10-yard line. And I think he's going to have enough for the first down. They stopped the clock just to look at it, and they moved, well, they didn't move the chains yet. And it's going to be second down and one.
Yeah, we're just shy.
I saw the chains move.
Not as shy as the other one, but.
I saw the chains move, so I thought they were going to have it, but he's.
Yeah, this is about a couple feet.
So, okay, whistle on the floor.
Yeah, it didn't.
Wanted to restart the
play
clock.
Yep.
Yeah, restart the play clock. So, third and one for the Bronx at the Cimarron 9-yard line. Under 30 seconds to play. Maddox bobbled the snap, and the ball is loose. Picked up by Cimarron. Trace Copper with it.
And there's a face mask.
He's still going.
I believe that's a face mask or a horse collar or something.
Yes. I believe that was Armando Salcedo that saved a touchdown, but Trace Copper picked that ball up at about the seven or eight-yard line. But I saw Maddox bobble the snap and must not have had a handle on it when he tried to attempt the handoff to Coulter. So first and 10 Blue Jays. 11 seconds to go in our first quarter. And if that's from the spot of the foul, that's going to be a huge play for Cimarron. And they've got the lights on here at the stadium. I was thinking there for a minute we was going to play with the glow ball.
Yeah, a lot of conversation going on down here.
About what?
About
the light?
Well, no, with the penalties, taking a little while.
Well, in high school, I don't think they tack it at the end of the run.
No, I'm pretty sure it's a spot.
I think it's going to be a spot foul. Hey, you know what? If I'm a coach, I'm happy we have the football at the 48, you know?
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Of course, you want the extra 15 for the face mask, but let's see what they do. And they are going to step it off, so I wasn't sure how they do that, but man, they're going to step it off at the end of the run. Great starting field position for Cimarron. First and 10 from just inside the Bronx 37-yard line. Wow, big play. Yeah. 11 seconds to go in our first quarter. Cimarron football, first and 10 from the Bronx 37. Okay.
What was the other one there? Just said so, unsportsmanlike.
Well, he said after the play. I mean, the face mask wouldn't be after the play. It'd be after the possession change.
Yeah.
Now, to me, you would have declined that one and taken the dead ball personal foul. The unsportsmanlike or whatever it was.
Yeah, I'm a little confused on that one.
Yeah. But, I mean, ball is
loose.
And
we got it back.
And I think Lakin's going to get it back.
There's a flag down.
We do have a flag down.
Right at the line of scrimmage.
Did Lakin get that ball back, though?
Yes.
They did. Nobody came up celebrating, so I was wondering if they got it back.
I thought so. I thought I saw a Lakin guy on it.
Well, I thought I saw a purple shirt on it, but that ball does funny things when a body lands on it.
I'll say their quarterback's still out there in their whole offense, so.
So we'll wait and see. It's either a loss of two with a penalty.
Holding on the offense. That penalty will be declined. And it will be first down.
Lakin with the recovery. There, it is. There we go. All right.
Man, this referee is sure making you wonder. He's putting a lot of suspense in every time he's turning on his mic.
Exactly. And you know what? I know who the official is. We're not going to say the name because I don't want to say names over the air. But a very veteran official, and he's going to – I think he's going to just take his time to make it right.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's adding a lot of suspense.
Yeah. And I like the referee mic that they've got going right now, too. It helps us to kind of know what's
really
going on.
Loud and clear this year.
Yeah.
Past years, it hadn't been too great, but this year it's really great.
Well, I'll tell you what, credit Trevor Leeper with the sound system up here. I mean, a lot of stuff. I mean, there's, like I said, there's a way to tie in the public address over us. There's a way to tie the referee mic on us. And if I hadn't have been just busy shooting a bull with Trevor before we got started, I'd have probably tried to do that ref mic.
Yeah, season's not over yet.
I know. Coulter off the right side, off the left side across the 40. And that's going to do it for our first quarter.
Oh, man, I thought it was halftime.
Hey, it's only – well, you know, that was a 42-minute quarter, though.
I was going to say, that seemed extremely long.
Yep, it really did, matter of fact. So our first quarter brought to you by Matt Medill, CPA. Thanks, Matt. We appreciate all you do for us here on Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube. Our second quarter brought to you by Flashbacks Diner.
Flashback to the days of Bebop and Bobby Sox at Flashback's Diner, Highway 50, Lakin. Fantastic burgers, Coney and Chicago hot dogs, Philly, steak, BLT, and chicken sandwiches, along with ice cream treats like the traditional banana split, sundaes, shakes, malts, and cones. Dine in or carry out. Flashback to the days of Bebop and Bobby Sox at the one and only Fantastic Flashback's Diner, Highway 50, Lakin.
Welcome back to Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube. Brett and Jared with you. Thanks for joining us tonight for Bronx football. Homecoming and alumni night here at the stadium. I know tonight at 5 o'clock, alumni could meet at the high school for a facilities tour. Don't know how many took advantage of that, but always nice when alumni can come back and see some changes made from when they attended. And I'll tell you what, from when I graduated, we won't say how many years ago, there have been a lot of changes to the school. Now, the original buildings are still there, but, man, have they changed on the inside.
Yeah, I can definitely tell you I went there for that walkthrough.
You weren't there?
Nope. Pretty sure I still know them.
You know what? It's still the same as when you went to school.
Yeah, a lot of changes since I've been out, too.
Give is to Ryder off the left side. Out near midfield, brought down. They're going to give him to the 49-yard line.
Man, since I've been out, they put down two new gym floors. Got the high school one and then the rubber gym.
Yep.
So they've done two new floors since I've been out.
Well, the rubber
and
gym.
New turf field.
Yeah, the rubber gym wasn't replaced, though. They just put a paint coat
on top
of it.
Well, they redid it. Yeah.
Yeah. That floor was put in when I was a junior in high school.
That was the cafeteria.
Yes, it was for you, wasn't it?
No.
It wasn't for you?
For you.
No, it wasn't either.
Mine was the middle school.
Mine was the grade school.
Oh, yeah, you're right, because you had to run there to make sure that you got lunch and got back.
Well, we weren't ever hurried for lunch, but I'll tell you what, we were some world-class sprinters sprinting from the high school to the grade school for lunch.
Yeah.
And you would look at me today and you'd think, no, there's no way that boy ran. I led the pack, man.
Yeah, I bet so.
You know, you call me a lot of things, but you ain't going to call me late for dinner.
Yeah, you probably knew all the alleys and the yards to get through to get there first.
Oh, I definitely did. I'll tell you what, there was a backyard that everybody would cut through, and that gentleman would be waiting for us at lunchtime, man. He did not like us cutting across the back his back lot.
I think it'd be entertaining.
But me being the good guy, I always ran around the block. I didn't cut across. And honestly, I didn't, because I knew he was waiting for us.
Yeah.
So while he slowed the other guys down, I made the pass on the outside.
lots of different things being thrown out.
And they never throw it to me. Maybe they can throw it to you.
If they got a football, I bet I could hit you.
Well, you might be able to.
Yeah, I could hit you. Or a T-shirt.
Rider around the left side. We'll have enough for the first down, brought down by Colby Wilson.
I don't know about the Frisbee. I don't think I'd be able to toss the Frisbee through that window.
Yeah, there's no way I'd even attempt to throw a Frisbee. I'm not a good Frisbee thrower.
I might hit a couple people on the way. Because the wind's starting to pick up a little bit, so.
Oh, no, it's not. Look at
these flags.
These
flags are flying.
Really?
Yeah, these are all flying that way.
The American flag is not hardly moving at all.
Well, that's a little bit heavier, too.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
it's probably a nice little 5 mile an hour.
First and 10 Bronx from the 32-yard line. Pitch, ball is on the ground.
And
I think
Cimarron's got it.
Do they? I thought Lakin might have reached in.
I think Cimarron had
the
first.
No, oh. Lakin's got it. Armando able to reach in and grab that football.
I think again with though. And I think he disrupted it.
So a loss back to about the 42-yard line. It's going to be second and 15 for the Bronx. Man, teams have had a lot of troubles hanging on to the football tonight. That's the third time I think the Bronx have had the football on the ground.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Give up the middle. Oldham ran into a blocker. Dragged down by number 25, Holden Kite. Going to get out almost to the original line of scrimmage. You'll get to the 38-yard line where it'll be third and 12. Clock running at 9 minutes to go in our half. Bronx was receiver split to each side. Maddox under center, third and 12. Rider in motion. Pass out to the flat to Oldham. We've got a flag on the play.
I believe that's going to be holding.
Yeah, that one's going to come back.
Man, they are definitely going after the ball. They are ripping every time that they start standing people up.
Holding Lakin. So that'll be from the line of scrimmage. So that's going to take them back to the Lakin about 48-yard line. So instead of third and 12, it's going to be third and 22. So third and 22 for the Bronx. .825 to go in our half. Bronx lead at 14-12. Granado split to the near side. Patterson to the far side. Salcedo faked in motion. Maddox up the line, will pitch it. Ryder has Rumor off the left side across the 40, the 30. He's up the sideline and knocked out of bounds. Trace Copper saved a Bronx touchdown there. Ryder out at the just shy of the 25-yard line. Should have enough for the first down.
Oh, yeah, he should be.
That time you saw another gear with Ross Ryder up that sideline.
Yeah, I would have been a little bit afraid being that safety back there, have to make that tackle because he's going to run right over you. He had quite the speed going.
Yeah, he got to about the 40 and then he just shifted gears.
He definitely found an extra gear there.
So first and 10 Bronx from the Cimarron 25-yard line. Oldham with the handoff across the 20, dragging white shirts across the 15. And he's going to have another Bronx first down. But I'll tell you what, for all the yards Colter Oldham fought for last week, he's fighting for him this week, but he's carrying defenders with him.
big man, you got to take him down by the legs, because if not, they're going to keep pumping and he's going to keep on going.
Well, and he's got the strength that he is going to keep going.
Oh, yeah.
But last week, like I said, struggled a little bit with the run game last week. But this week, Bronx were able to pick up the extra yardage. So and first and 10.
And like I said, just got to make sure we hold on to that ball, because they are ripping every time they stand you up.
First and 10 from the 15. Give off the left side. Oldham dragging the pile once again. He's going to get down to just inside the 10, maybe the 9. So a gain of 5 on the play brings up second down and 5.
I'm going to come over here and find me an end zone seat.
Should we just put you up a chair there?
Might as well. I might steal this guy's chair.
You know, that's one thing about it. We've got a good FM transmitter. You can hear us that far out.
Oh, yeah.
Ryder, the carry up the middle. Now it's a rugby scrum, and which one's going to win? They're going to finally blow it dead. Forward progress to about the 7-yard line. So that's going to bring up a third and about 2 for the Bronx.
Yeah, I don't mind this perspective. I know we watched an NFL game one time from this perspective, and it's kind of neat seeing the holes open up and runner getting through.
And yeah, that's what's neat about an end zone seat, especially in college or the NFL. The greatest end zone seat I ever had was to be able to watch Barry Sanders.
Oh, yeah, that would have been.
Oh, my goodness, if that wasn't that something.
Oh, no, Dalvin Cook was another good one.
Yeah, he's no Barry Sanders.
Well, that is true, but getting to watch it from 3 rows up and in the end zone, that was a pretty cool game.
Bronx enough for the first down, first and goal from the Cimarron 3-yard line.
I'm ready to get back to the stadium. Except this will be a home stadium this time.
Yeah, I don't want to hear it. You're gonna come back with tears in your eyes anyway.
Oh yeah, of joy.
No.
Yeah, that's gonna be so fun. I'm so ready. Well, win or lose, I don't care.
Hell, I'm happy you're gonna get to go. I just wish I could have maybe found a way to go with you, but that's okay.
Yeah, it's fine.
Colter Oldham off the left side, 3-yard touchdown. And the Bronx add to their lead.
We going for kick or we going for 2?
Looks like we're going to go for 2. I don't see a T being run out.
Oh, and there's the fireworks. Getting a little bit better to see them now.
That is so cool. I love it.
Now, if only we could just get a pyro personal. You could put them up there and just press a button, have them preloaded.
Yeah. Oh, that's asking a little bit too much. It's enough that I can find somebody that just lights them manually.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, stood up.
Try for the point is no good. But with 5:27 to go in the half, Bronx lead at 20-12. I think everything's still working good, I think. So well, thank you everybody for joining us here on Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube. Our second quarter brought to you by Flashbacks Diner. We're back with the kick right after this.
Flash back to the days of Bebop and Bobby Socks at Flashbacks Diner, Highway 50, Lakin. Fantastic burgers, Coney and Chicago hot dogs, Philly, steak, BLT, and chicken sandwiches, along with ice cream treats like the traditional banana split, sundaes, shakes, malts, and cones. Dine in or carry out. Flash back to the days of Bebop and Bobby Socks at the one and only Fantastic Flashbacks Diner, Highway 50, Lakin.
.527 remaining in our first half. Bronx now leading the Blue Jays 20-12. To Last I saw in the second quarter, Holcomb was up over Goodland by the score of 13-0. A score from the area. Armando Salcido set to kick it for the Bronx. Trace Copper and David Mendez back to return for the Blue Jays. Both standing right around their 10-yard line. High end over end kick, bobbled at the 9, picked up at the 8 by Copper. Up the right side, he's got an opening. There's a flag behind the play. Copper cuts it back inside, and he's brought down. That was Ross Ryder, I believe, catching him from behind. But that one's coming back with that flag behind the play. And now Holcomb on top of Goodland, 21-0. So blindside block on Cimarron. So from the spot of the foul, that'll put them back to about the 11-yard line. So Trace Copper is definitely one that the Bronx have got to contain and don't give him those big returns. He had that fumble recovery that was tacked on by a face mask penalty, but right there he was very close to taking that one to the house. So Trace Copper, very, very much their quickest player that I've seen. Although Holden Kite on his 65-yard kick return did a great job with his speed and return ability too. So the penalty backs it up to the Cimarron 12-yard line. First and 10 Blue Jays, 5:14 to go in the first half. Copper from the gun, high snap, hands it off to Kite.
Man, the running back on that one kind of went up for it too, just to make sure that nothing happened.
And both of them pretty much just standing side by side. So,
yeah, they were making sure that that wasn't going over the head.
So a pickup of 1 brings up 2nd down and 9. Copper once again from the gun. Kite standing next to him. Now Copper will keep it around the right side.
Oh,
fighting ahead for yardage, and I think he's going to have the first down.
Yep.
First down, Blue Jays, from the Cimarron 25-yard line. Clock stopped at 4:20 to go in our first half. A lot of action, but just a slow-paced first half.
Yeah, well, when you have a first quarter that takes so long and then a second quarter is kind of flying, it feels really different.
Kite, the ball carrier, brought down by Jeremy Orpiza. I think it's getting to that time of night. I can't see the black letters on the purple jerseys. So,
yeah, and it's always a pile, so I can't ever see who comes up from them either.
And that might not. I think that was Timmy Johnson actually on the stop. Yeah, that's something JD and I always talked about. It was always hard to per se pick a defensive player of the game or something like that, because you'd see a lot of purple shirts on a tackle, but the way they swarm to the football, it's always hard to see who gets the immediate tackle. First and 10 Blue Jays. Copper with the fake, now rolls to the right side. Steps across the 30. Clock will run. He's across the 30 to about the 30, let's see here, 32-yard line. So a 3rd and 3 for the Blue Jays after that 7-yard gain by Trace Copper. And we
ref timeout for something.
Yeah, I could hear something in the background. The coach saying water, water, water. So I didn't know if we had a official's timeout for water, but no. Here we go. Third and three. Copper off the right side, wrapped up, spun around, and the flag comes in late, and I think that's going to be a late hit by Lakin.
Which he wasn't touching the turf, actually. He was on top of another player, so. But in quarterback.
So an unfortunate play there would have been fourth and five, and this late flag, I think, is going to be against Lakin. Unfortunate defensive play there for the Bronx, because they very well could have gotten that football back. So a 15-yard personal foul.
Man, that's unfortunate. Think could have held them there.
Would have been an interesting fourth and five call, definitely, from that spot. So now Cimarron with the first and 10 from their 45-yard line. I want to thank Allie Mead on our camera. Quick pass to the near side.
Wow, he was lit up there.
Maddox Beltran just lit up Logan Heddleston.
I'd love hearing that pad pop.
And the thing about it is, at first I thought Maddox, by the way the bodies landed, he might have taken that ball away from him, but of course he didn't. It's second and nine. Clock running at 2:15 to go in our first half. So the twin receivers to the far side, twin receivers to the near side, they stack them. Low snap.
Ball down.
Ball is out. Loose. And I think it's a Bronx recovery.
Wow, great play there.
Eli Bemis,
yep,
all over Trace Copper. And on the return, on the recovery is Javion Granato.
Yep. Great play there.
So the Bronx in great field position with 1:57 to go in our first half. But man, Eli Bemis all over Copper on that high snap. Well, actually, it was a low snap that he had to go down and get.
Yeah,
my bad.
It was a good heads up, though, to be able to see if that ball was there.
Yep. So the Bronx with great starting field position from the Cimarron 37-yard line.
Well, I just picked up another game for about a second. Someone's on the 19-yard line, so. Didn't stay long, though, so that's a plus.
Oldham fighting for extra yards is going to gain 11 yards on the play. And another Bronx first down. Well, you don't need to give me Holcomb Goodland updates because JD's doing a good job with that. So
yeah, I was going to say, let it be his job for once.
That's probably who you're listening to is. Run our clock down.
Oh.
To the near side.
Go a little hurry.
Oldham with it again. Gain of two brings up second down and eight. Did I lose the mic, Jared, or did you turn it off?
No, I turned and it disconnected, but then I turned back and it's good.
Counter to Salcedo. Peyton Dye in on the stop for the Blue Jays. No gain on the play. Third down and eight. Right here would be a good time for Maddox to put it in the air.
Yeah, I was thinking that's why I'm kind of standing back here in the corner.
Have
nice,
not attempted
nice post
one yet.
A post route or something like that, I think, just loft them on up and over.
And a timeout on the field with 36 seconds to go in the half. Bronx used their second timeout. So we'll see what the Bronx staff can draw up here on a third and eight At the half, Holcomb on top of Goodland, 21-0. Our halftime sponsor tonight, Golden Plains Credit Union. And also Shelter Insurance, Kearney County Community Development. And we'll take a look back at the first half, look at some things going on around the area. And tomorrow, a big event here at Lakin, the Run, Drive, and Fly. Big event at the airport. Starts off tomorrow morning with a 5K run. And the car show at the Lakin Airport, followed by the air show. That's one thing that I've always thought about with the air show now on Alumni Weekend here on Homecoming. They need to get one of those planes to do a flyover pregame.
Oh, yeah, that'd be really interesting. I thought you were going to say...
That'd be neat.
I thought you were going to say that you needed to get in the 5K.
Yeah, you're funny. And I know you were going to laugh about it, too.
Oh, yeah.
You really probably could have hammered me pretty good on that one, but I'll give you credit. You were nice to the old man that time. Timeout Lakin, their third and final timeout of the half. Going to bring up a fourth on a long two for the Bronx.
Man, I don't know what the deal is now, but now that I'm over here, I'm picking up that other game pretty good. I got to keep my head facing a certain way so I can hear you.
Oh, okay. One thing I've noticed, this is what, just our second home game, and even on the road, Lakin's got a rowdy student section that are having a great time.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, I mentioned it last time. Always love seeing the student section get into it.
All part of the excitement of Friday night football. Wind picking up a little bit out of the east-southeast now. I just wish it'd blow in this wind into the window here. You know, if I had an opening on the back wall here, I would get a breeze through. There's nowhere to go. So fourth and two for the Bronx from the Cimarron 20-yard line. Is that a reverse to Orpisa?
Oh, he's going to call him short.
I think that was a reverse to Jeremy Orpisa. Is that number two over there, Jared?
Yeah, I believe so.
So they ran a reverse to Orpisa. I was thinking that was him.
Yeah, I've got the Holcomb Goodland game again, so I'm trying to get back to you.
So first and goal from the Blue Jay 1 yard line. 20 seconds to go in our half. Give us to Oldham, and he's through for the touchdown. What was that?
Holding on offense.
Oh, my goodness. So that'll bring up first and goal now from the Cimarron 11-yard line. I didn't see that flag come in.
I didn't either. I just saw him blowing it dead, so.
So first and goal from the 11. Holding penalty wipes out the Oldham touchdown. And we've got a whistle on the play.
I don't know what we... Cimarron coach coming out.
Yeah, I don't know what that was about, but pretty uneventful anyway. So first and goal from the 11. Maddox from the gun. Will throw.
There's our pass here.
Going to be just shy of the end zone, but it's at the 1 yard line. Clock will be stopped. The completion was to Armando Salcido. So second and goal with 9 seconds to go in the half. Bronx with no timeouts. So if they try one on the ground, they better score with it. In the Bronx go type formation. Maddox will take it.
And he's in.
And he's in for the touchdown.
Hey, don't forget to tell Allie to throw the camera over there at the end of the game.
At the end of the game, yeah, exactly, yeah.
Are we going to do that and then coach's interview? Or?
Probably so.
Okay, sounds good. I'll just keep that mic and everything with me then.
Okay. Bronx going for two. Coulter easily walks it in. And with that, the Bronx extend their lead to 28-12 with 6 seconds remaining in our first half. As the Lakin High School pep band, under the direction of Kaylin Anderson with the school song, fans on their feet enjoying themselves tonight.
Yeah, it feels beautiful down here. I don't know if you're catching much of that breeze.
But, not at all.
And it's blowing this way to you, so I would think that you'd be getting a little bit. But
well, I get it right at the window, but if I had something to let it blow through, it'd be beautiful in here.
Just need to get you a fan up there. I know there's a fan right above you.
Yeah,
they got one up there.
Yeah, they stole it from us down here.
Looks like you need to have a talk with them there.
No, I just think with my sweet talking over the last 17 years that I deserve air conditioning and heating in this room. Onside kick. Lakin waited for it to go 10 yards.
We have the ball.
If they give them to the 50, it's a good onside kick. Lakin did a good job of surrounding that football. The clock did not start on that play. So still 6 seconds remain. What a way to end a half if the Bronx were to recover that.
Oh, yeah. Just lob one downfield.
And it is.
And it is Lakin.
Lakin with the onside kick. Coach Bamberger going to the bag of tricks on that one.
It's a good call there.
So the Bronx first and 10 from midfield after the onside kick. Only 6 seconds remain, but you know what? Hey, a lot of things can happen. Bronx with no timeouts. Cimarron with two.
Yeah, all it takes is one long ball, and hopefully not an interception.
Yeah, that goes the other way. Yeah, no kidding.
Unless they tackle him, then it doesn't matter anyways.
Yeah, don't talk about that. Don't say that too loud. Maddox from the gun.
And there it is.
Pass almost picked off. Or Pisa.
That's not who they wanted it to go to. Coaches weren't happy about that one. They wanted it floated out to Coulter, but nonetheless, no harm, no foul.
Yep, that was an incomplete intended for Armando Salcido. But, you know, it's one of those two that you floated up out there and let Armando run under it, too.
Yeah.
You know, with his speed.
That just wasn't what they dialed up because coaches weren't too happy about that one.
Probably an underneath type of screen to Coulter with blockers out in front, I would imagine. That's the end of our first half. The score, Lakin 28, Cimarron 12. Our second quarter brought to you by Flashbacks Diner.
Flashback to the days of Bebop and Bobby Sox at Flashbacks Diner, Highway 50, Lakin. Fantastic burgers, Coney and Chicago hot dogs, Philly, steak, BLT, and chicken sandwiches, along with ice cream treats like the traditional banana split, sundaes, shakes, malts, and cones. Dine in or carry out. Flashback to the days of Bebop and Bobby Sox at the one and only Fantastic Flashbacks Diner, Highway 50, Lakin.
Our halftime sponsor tonight, the Golden Plains Credit Union.
Refinance your auto loan at Golden Plains Credit Union. You can lower your current auto loan rate by 2% with no payments for up to 90 days. Rates can be as low as 3.25% annual percentage rate. This offer applies to loans financed from another lender. Think of all the money you could be saving every month. This is a limited time offer, so stop by and ask about refinancing your auto loan today. Golden Plains Credit Union. Life with a touch of gold. Member NCUA.
Our halftime thoughts and recap brought to you by Shelter Insurance. But before we go to that, we've got a halftime performance by the Lakin High School cheerleaders. So we'll keep it right here for the dance presentation by the Lakin High School cheerleaders.
Junior Hollywood Road. And senior Maggie Dennett. Senior Vanessa Lewis. And senior Al Dallas Garcia.
And our halftime performance by the Lakin High School cheerleaders. We're back with some halftime thoughts and recap brought to you by Shelter Insurance, a big red, white, and blue shelter sign, East Highway 50 in Lakin.
A lot of action on the street today, huh, Willie?
Yep. Oh, check out the German V8.
Good car.
Arf, Wiedersehen.
Ooh, 64 dream car.
At Shelter Insurance, we insure all your favorite rides.
Oh, classic convertible.
And have since 1946.
Sweet pickup. Hiya, Muggsy.
Yo.
From Hot Wheels to hybrids, we've got you covered.
Hey, mailman.
Love those shoes.
Hey, where you going?
Shelter Insurance. We're your shield. We're your shelter.
Welcome back to Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube. We are at the half. The Bronx leading the Blue Jays by the score of 28-12. We talked earlier of some events going on around the area, and of course the big one tomorrow is the Run, Drive, and Fly, starting out at here in Lakin with the 5K run and the car show at the Lakin Airport, followed by the air show. So a big event here in Lakin has been moved last year to the alumni weekend, and I think it's great to have that in conjunction with it. A lot of people coming back to town. Of course, the alumni banquet is tomorrow night, but that event, I didn't go out to the airport to watch the air show. Actually, I see it rather well from just the outskirts of town. I can even watch it from my front porch, but air shows always interest me, especially the big ones when the big boys come to play. And we're talking about the Thunderbirds or the Blue Angels, things like that. But if you've never been to an air show, they're exciting no matter what the size. So go out to the Lakin Airport tomorrow. And if you're up for it, go run 5K before you go. I'm going to take a pass, but somebody out there can run it for me. I'll be at Lakin Rec Football tomorrow morning, live right here on the turf here in Lakin. Rec football starting with the third and fourth graders at 9:30, the fifth and sixth graders following at 11 o'clock. And also here in town tomorrow, Lakin JV Volleyball. Here at the Lakin Middle School gym, the varsity is at Holcomb, the C team is at Ulysses. And cross country at Stanton County tomorrow. For some reason, my clock won't let me reset. Let me try this. Let's reset that to 14 minutes. I don't. Did it let me? No, it didn't let me. So we'll wait till that clock hits 12 minutes and then we'll start running it down for the half. No, for some reason, I don't know why that will not let me do that, but it doesn't. So halftime thoughts and recap. Jared ran inside, but the Bronx got it started early. Armando Salcedo with a 23-yard run. The Maddox Beltran run failed, but the Bronx led it 6-0. On the ensuing kickoff, Holden Kite took the Armando Salcedo kickoff 65 yards, and the conversion run failed. And we were tied at 6 with 8:52 to go in the first quarter. Trace Copper gave Cimarron their only lead in the first half at 6:51 to go in the first on a 3-yard run. Two-point conversion was no good, but Cimarron with the 12-6 lead. And then the Bronx retook the lead with a Maddox Beltran 1-yard run. Coulter with the 2-point conversion, and the Bronx were back on top 14-12 with 4:42 to go in our first half. Colter Oldham added a 3-yard run with 5:27 to go in the half. The 2-point conversion failed, and the Bronx led it 20-12. And then Maddox finished off the scoring with a 1-yard run with 14 seconds remaining in the half. And the Colter Oldham 2-point conversion, and that's where we stand at the half. Bronx leading it 28-12. The Bronx 2-1 on the season, trying to keep the Blue Jays winless. The Blue Jays come into tonight 0-3. And the Bronx trying to win their second in a row over the Blue Jays after they snapped a 8-game losing streak to the Blue Jays last year with the win at Cimarron. And right now, the Bronx looking good, up by 16 at half, but still a lot of football to go here on the turf here at Lakin. Lakin High School pep band entertaining the folks here at halftime. I want to thank Levi Perez with the firing of the fireworks for us tonight. And there will be more of the show after the football game. Jared, thank you very much.
Oh, not a problem. Tried to do my best.
Yeah. That's why we pay you well.
Exactly.
Hey, did you by chance see our camera girl maybe down for the half, or she's still upstairs?
She was just right over here.
Hey, you might track her down and tell her about the post-game fireworks.
Walking back up.
Okay.
She's coming through the press box.
See if I can get her attention. I don't know. I may hit the broadcast guys. Yeah, there's somebody behind the door. I'll text her.
Yeah, Schmidt's doing an interview up there, so.
Yeah. Well, you were talking about the 5K run, Jared, tomorrow.
Yeah, what about it?
I just got a text that Bryant's thinking about it.
That who is?
Bryant.
Oh. Well, power to him.
You know what? He said he doesn't think he's going to do it, but it's the thought that counts.
Yeah, I was going to say. It might be one of those late game time decisions, huh?
Yeah, I might have to pull out, you know, light hammy pull or something like that. Might have to pull out late.
Yeah, yeah. I know how that is.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I'd pull my back out, probably just lacing up my shoes, so I'm not going to do it.
That's how I would be, too. It sucks having to warm up for stuff now.
Yeah. Hey, believe me, it only gets harder.
Yeah, I was going to say, you got to get all those fast active muscles.
It does.
You got to get them firing first.
Yeah, it does not get easier, believe me.
But I guess once I get my hips back in line, I think I'd be feeling a lot better. But, man, it's been kicking me. Haven't had issues with it since high school, but now all of a sudden I think it was because of running with the track kids. Yeah, I think doing that kind of threw my body for a loop. Wasn't ready for it. Well, we got 8 minutes. Doesn't seem like you got much to talk about.
Well, I shouldn't be texting on the air, but.
Here, I got a fun fact for you that I learned today.
I just wanted to check in with Allie.
So there is one NFL team that has absolutely no white in its logo. What team would that be?
No white in its logo.
Absolutely zero white. You got 32 choices, so take you a while to get through them.
Now, is it just the logo on the helmet?
Just their logo. Their logo.
Well, I'm thinking logo-wise would be the Las Vegas Raiders because they're black and silver.
But no, it's
but
white.
I'm thinking,
their logo's white.
Well, it's actually silver, isn't it? I don't know.
No, it's all white because that was someone's guess, too.
Now, I'm thinking about helmet would be the Cincinnati Bengals at orange and black.
Or the Browns.
No, but they have a white stripe down the middle.
Oh, yeah, that's true. It's just logo, not helmet.
Just logo. Okay, well, let me think. Oh, I'll come up with it eventually.
I want to say it's AFC.
Oh, you don't know the answer?
Oh, no, I know it.
Oh.
I think it's AFC.
Oh, okay. You don't know your teams as well as I do.
I know the teams. I just don't really know the divisions as well. I know the North, and I know your AFC. That's about it.
Okay. Wow. Don't tell me yet.
I have a hint that would completely give it away, but that would
be
any fun.
I don't want a hint yet. I know it's not. Man, it's not the Broncos. It's not the Chiefs. Okay, you proved me wrong on the Raiders. Chargers? No, they got white in there.
White
got
lime. They got in the center of it's white.
Yeah, they got a lot of white on theirs. Steelers, Browns, Bengals, Baltimore. They've got white. Jacksonville Jaguars.
Nope.
Okay.
The Jaguars' eyes white. I believe. I don't know. They got white somewhere.
You're probably right.
I just know that's not the answer.
Houston Texans have white outline.
Yep.
Colts have white dots in the horseshoe.
just 8 simple steps in a life that works.
Wow.
And it's pretty obvious once you start thinking of colors. You think like the team's two main colors, and you start thinking of it. It's like, oh, well, yeah, that's a no-brainer.
Buffalo Bills?
No. Nope.
Okay, I've gone through every AFC team then.
Okay, well, then I guess it's NFC. Well, they're on the west side of the United States, so I figured that would be.
Well, the only one out there is the Chargers and the Raiders in Vegas now. So,
Maybe it's NFC then. I was wrong.
Well, I'll start up the West Coast. It's the Rams, the 49ers, the Seahawks. But the Seahawk eye is white.
Yeah, and I think they got an outline too.
Yeah. Well, sorry to bore everybody at home with this.
They're probably trying to think too.
Trivia going nowhere. Gosh. Cardinals, the eye of the Cardinals white.
Yeah, and I think they're outlined as well. That's what gets a lot of people is a lot of logos are outlined.
Cowboys, Giants, Eagles have some white. Washington Commanders with that W on it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yep, they're only maroon and yellow.
Maroon and yellow.
No outline at all.
Yeah, the gold W.
Now, if they would have still been the Redskins, there wouldn't be a single team.
Well, yeah, I mean, I wouldn't even have thought of that. As soon as I thought Washington, I thought, okay, that's red and gold.
Yeah, I was going to say, that. It took me forever just because, but then once I started thinking of just two different colors, I was like, oh, well, now it's kind of obvious.
Yeah. Well, you know what, hey, that helps my brain power, gets me thinking.
Yeah, you got to keep it fresh.
That's right, yeah.
I don't think I got anything else for you.
You don't have anything
I
else.
I think that's the only one that I got.
Okay, well.
I always see random stuff like that, but.
Well, I've got a halftime score from Goodland. Holcomb on top of Goodland 21-0. So that's kind of where we stand. Oh, actually 35-0 in the third quarter, Holcomb, so.
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought their halftime was over.
Yeah, it's 35-0.
Yeah, I don't think I got anything else. I don't got any more history or trivia or nothing.
Well, I guess that was probably enough.
I guess, yeah. Yep. We still got 2 minutes, but.
Well, we're going to take a timeout. Our halftime sponsor, Golden Plains Credit Union, our halftime thoughts and recap, Shelter Insurance. Our halftime interview, even though we didn't get one, I guess we just interviewed Jared. So that brought to you by the Kearney County Community Development, and that's who we're going to hear from. We're going to go to a laundry list made up by JD of all the great sponsors here right after this, too.
Kearney County, a wonderful life opportunity, offers a wide range of opportunities to residents and visitors. Hunting, fishing, camping, golfing, and bowling provide recreation, plus the Lake and Rec Commission provides youth and adult programs in Lakin and Deerfield. Explore the rich history of the county by visiting the Kearney County Historical Museum or the historic sites throughout the county. Take advantage of what Kearney County has to offer. Contact Ralph Goodnight, Kearney County Economic Development, or on the web at www.kearneycountykansas.com.
LakenSports.com could not bring you Lakin High Sports without the continued support of our great sponsors. Thanks to these great businesses, the KCB Bank of Lakin and Garden City, the agency of Lakin and Garden City, your full-line insurance agency, Lakin Hay and the Lakin Dairy, Fred Ripsema, Shelter Insurance, Gwen Wechter, East Highway 50, Lakin, Flashbacks Diner, West Highway 50, Lakin, the Golden Plains Credit Union, Life with a Touch of Gold, the Lakin Recreation Commission, Lakin Drug, 610 O'Laughlin, Lakin, Shorty's Cafe, Main Street, Lakin, the Kearney County Economic Development, Ralph Goodnight, Pioneer Communications of Southwest Kansas, Hendricks Welding, Brad Hendricks, and Debock Metals of Lakin, Player of the Game Medal sponsor. Again, thank you, sponsors. Please let them know you appreciate what they do. Now back we go with the voice of Lake and High Sports, Brett Hendricks.
And I want to thank J.D. Hamm for the laundry list and all of the technical work he does for us here on Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube. As I've said before, and will always continue to say it, without J.D., there would never have been a LakeandSports.com. .240 as they put another 3 minutes on the clock before we get set in our second half. The Bronx will kick, as Cimarron won the opening toss and deferred to the second half. So the Bronx will be kicking to start the second half. Slight breeze blowing out of the southeast, but just a beautiful night for football.
Couldn't ask for anything better. Perfect night for the fireworks too. Won't have any malfunctions or issues.
Let's hope not.
Should be pretty easy to light with the torches.
Well, I remember last year we didn't even decide to do it till just into the fourth quarter when the wind finally died down.
Yeah, and we ran over and got everything out of the tote.
Yeah, so you did see the lighters that I bought, didn't you?
Yeah, the mini torches.
Yeah, the mini torches.
Yeah, those will be perfect.
Hey, only the best.
I need to grab one of those.
No, you don't get to take it home.
No, I got one at the house. I'm just saying, so after the game's over, I could run over there and get everything going.
Yeah.
Are we doing it just like directly after the game and just going from there?
I did talk to coach, and they reset the clock. We got 12 minutes on there, so we're ready to go.
Perfect.
I did tell coach that we were going to fire fireworks, and he had no problem with them going off immediately after the game. So
perfect. All righty then.
So I think that's what we're going to do. So,
I'll just try to mosey on down here towards the end of the fourth quarter and go from there.
Yeah, and the thing about it is we can fire those fireworks while the teams are on the field telling each other good game, and by the time they get to the huddle, they might be about done. So,
yeah. I'll say it's for the fans anyways.
Exactly.
Want to light them off before they get out of here.
Yeah, you might tell Levi, you might mosey down there a little bit and just say, hey, as soon as we're done, we'll fire them off.
Okay, sounds good. I'll do that, and then I'll come back.
Salcedo with the kick, fielded by the up man, Logan Heddleston. And the Blue Jays will start the second half, first and 10 at the Blue Jay 40-yard line. Bronx on top, 28-12. Bronx looking to bounce back from that disappointing road loss at Goodland last week, and looking to improve their record to 3-1. Tell you what I can feel leaning out the window, that breeze feels great. Twin receivers both sides. The stack from the left side comes in a little tighter. Copper from the gun. Give off the right side. Give is to McCoy Nash. He's out across midfield into Lakin territory, and it's good for a first down. First and 10 Blue Jays from the Bronx 49-yard line. Copper with the snap. Fakes the give up the middle, follows him right through the hole. Bemis in on the play. Javion Granato in there as well. Gain of 4 on the play. Brings up second down and 6.
Well, I think we're all set with the fireworks now.
Excellent.
Should be good to go.
All right.
Man, I still got you over here. I'm over behind the car still.
Well, you know, earlier I had it clear out there, and then I turned one wrong way, and I started getting that radio feed. So
yeah, it was pretty good. I caught the Holcomb game just a couple times, and that's it.
Incomplete pass to the left side. We'll bring up third down and 6. And The answer to the question that Jared and I were talking about, it was the Washington Commanders. Just a straight gold W on their helmet, and their colors are maroon and gold. So pass to the left side, completed to Holden Kite. A short gain, if any. And we're going to leave it at fourth and six. So a big decision here for Cimarron on this opening possession of the second half. Fourth and six from just inside the Bronc 45-yard line. And Holcomb continues to pour it on Goodland, leading 42 to nothing. From the gun, Copper with a straight drop. Now he'll keep it. And he's got a receiver on the right side, and he overthrew him. Bronc catch a huge break.
Man, that could have been dangerous.
McCoy Nash got behind the defenders, and he would have tiptoed into the end zone. He could have just walked the rest of the way. So the Bronc with a break there. And they'll take over first and 10 from their four, just outside of their 45-yard line. So the Bronc defense with a stop on Cimarron's opening possession. Leading by 16, just underway second half. Brett and Jared with you. Thanks for joining us here on Lake and Bronc Sports YouTube. Thanks to Allie Mead on the camera tonight. Give is to Oldham. Leans it across midfield. Pickup of about 6 yards on the play. Bring up second and four. Bronc with the tight formation. Give is to Oldham off the right side. Copper and Seifried
on the stop. Just going to be short.
So it'll bring up third and one from the Blue Jay 46-yard line. Bobbled on the snap, and I think it's recovered by Cimarron.
We're going to be going the other way on that one.
And the Bronc, another bobble on the center quarterback exchange. That's about four times we've seen that tonight.
Man, this is looking familiar to another purple team I like. And I'm not liking it.
So the Blue Jays with the turnover, first and 10 from their 43-yard line after the Bronc defense had held them on downs. So good starting field position for Cimarron. Copper from the gun has been in the gun from the outset. Jayton Hash on the stop for Lakin there. Helped by a couple other purple shirts, but I saw the big 5'4 in there leading the charge.
That stack receiver thing that they run is interesting. I don't think I've ever seen that done.
Well, I've seen it, but it seems like it's every play.
Yeah, it's really unusual.
Usually you see that when they want to, you know, run a quick wide receiver screen or something like that.
Yeah,
but
just kind of an out route.
Copper with the snap, near side, Oldham chasing, and will catch him from behind. Ross Ryder also in on the stop. Gonna be a gain of about four, and will bring up third and six for the Blue Jays. Once again, I want to thank everybody for joining us here on Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube. Beautiful night for football here.
Yeah, I'm hoping it stays like this for the morning.
Yes, exactly. It's supposed to be a little bit cooler tomorrow, too. It won't be 90 anyway.
That's fine. I can put on a long sleeve to ref.
Copper from the gun being chased by Granado. He's got some room across midfield to the 40. Now brings it back this way. And he will be dragged down in Bronc territory at their 34-yard line. Like I said in the first half, the Bronx have got to try to contain Trace Copper.
Yeah, I believe that was one of their big keys to the game, too, is just make sure that he is stopped.
So first and 10 Blue Jays from the Bronc 34-yard line. Yeah, you're talking about rec football tomorrow starting at 9:30. Third and fourth graders, fifth and sixth graders at 11 o'clock. And we're right back here at the stadium tomorrow. Copper faked, now unloads it deep.
Oh, he's
and it's incomplete.
Oh, that was quite the grab.
Pass intended for Peyton Dye, and the Lakin receiver is down.
He's not moving.
And he has not moved since there he's up.
I think maybe kind of got the win.
Is that Ross Ryder?
I believe so.
And the trainer out there, they're gonna make him take a knee and check him out.
Yeah.
And you know what? Might as well. And that might have been a situation because he did come down on his back. He might have just aired himself.
Yeah, she just kind of got his hand on his back because I think he's got that back plate too. So
yeah.
Could have just kind of been a stinger.
Yeah, but great play by Ross to break that up. And he almost came away. Well, now that's Maddox.
Yeah, that's Maddox.
That is Maddox. I thought I saw number one, but then the one thing that gives me away with Maddox is the knee brace. That's where I can pick him out is the knee brace. But
I'll do some listening.
Yeah, Maddox holding his, kind of holding his lower back. But hey, got to be safe. Rather be safe than sorry. Second and 10 for the Blue Jays. And Holcomb on top of Goodland, 48-0. So that's going to be a running clock situation there. So second and 10, Blue Jays. Empty backfield. Quick pass to the left side. Kite with it. Drug down across the 30. Armando Salcido on the stop for Lakin brings up a third and 4 for the Blue Jays. Clock running, under 7 minutes to go in our third quarter. Want to congratulate homecoming queen Kenzie Loman Fuller, homecoming king Maddox Beltran. In the festivities earlier tonight, Copper quickly brought down. Bronx calling a blitz. Colder Oldham able to wrap him up. Going to be a loss on the play. A loss of 6. And that brings up 4th and 10 for the Blue Jays from the original line of scrimmage, the Bronx 33. Play clock down to 13 seconds. The Blue Jays have not broke the huddle yet. Now to 10. I'll reset our timeouts for the half. And that'll be a timeout, Cimarron. So I reset it to 3. Now they are back down to 2. Our third quarter brought to you by Shorty's Cafe. Shorty's Cafe got us on the monitors today in the dining room and in the club. And they will be open after the ball game for alumni and fans to hopefully celebrate a Bronx homecoming win. So thanks to Big E, and I want to thank our halftime sponsors as well. Golden Plains Credit Union Shelter Insurance, Kearney County Community Development, Ralph Goodnight. And once again, one of the items that I know Ralph was big on was the run, drive, and fly. And
well, a little update on Maddox. I think he just landed flat on his back with that back plate and was just having a lot of pain there in his lower back.
Okay.
Not entirely sure what we got coming up for him being on the field. Coach was asking him if he wants to take some snaps, so I guess we'll see how it is. Yeah. He is back on his feet.
He is back on his feet, which is a plus, but you can tell he's walking pretty gingerly.
Yeah, she was the trainer down here was rubbing quite a bit of Icy Hot and such on his back, so hopefully it just loosens back up for him.
Fourth and 10 for the Blue Jays. From the Bronc 33-yard line, receiver in motion to the near side. Copper from the gun, pass over the middle, over the intended target. And the Bronx once again will take over on downs, first and 10 from their 33-yard line. So twice the defense has handed the offense the football. So and Maddox trotting back out there. You can tell he's out there. He's running a little gingerly, but tell you what, he's gamer. He's going to play. Yeah. You know, watching him walk is just like how I look every time I get out of a chair. And I didn't land flat on my back.
Yeah, exactly. You didn't go up for a snatch and grab.
And they reset the play clock. Here we go. First and 10 Bronx front with a tight formation. Maddox back in under center. Pitch is to Ryder, and it's out in front of him. Ryder will recover it at the 18-yard line. So a huge loss for the Bronx. That's a loss of 15 yards on the play. So second and 25 for Lakin. So the Bronx with the turnover on downs, but a huge loss on their first play. Second and 25 from the Lakin 18-yard line. Give us to Oldham off the right side. Can't shake the first defender, but does take him across the 20 for about 5 yards. That'll bring up a long third down attempt. Third and 20 for the Bronx. From about the 24-yard line. Bronx will split them each side. Give is to Oldham. No, the fake is to Oldham. And Maddox keeps it around the right side. Trace Copper on the stop for Cimarron. A gain of about 5 yards. That'll bring up fourth and 15 for the Bronx. Copper back to return. Armando Salcido back to punt for the Bronx. High wobbly kick. Started to take a Cimarron bounce, but just basically stopped right there at the Cimarron 37-yard line where they'll have it first and 10. .336 to go in our third quarter. Third quarter's flying by compared to the first quarter. It was a long first quarter.
Yeah, I was saying, hearing down here that first half, they've had more snaps than they usually have in a whole game. Like 170-some, maybe?
Really? Wow, that's a lot of snaps.
Yeah, that's a lot. That's probably why that first quarter took so long.
Now, would that be between both teams? That'd have to be between both teams.
Yeah, between both. But, okay. Yeah, 170-some plays.
From the gun, Kite with it, looking for room near side. We've got a flag behind the play. And there are actually two flags on the play, but that's in that
I think
vicinity.
It's the same one.
Yeah, it's in that vicinity of a hold.
Yep.
And it is. Lakin, of course, will take it. That'll bring up a first and 20. That'll take them back to the 29-yard line. So actually, it'd be first and 19 because the original line of scrimmage was the 38. So it must have been a yard downfield. I thought the official ran the clock there, but it did not run here. Kite with it around the left side. Got to the 31-yard line before he is pushed back. So I'll run our clock back up. So.
Got another injury. They're making him go off for a play.
And
we'll find out
one.
What this one is, too.
Well, by the indication I got, as he took a shot to the head, I saw the official
hit
the side of his head.
That motion, yeah. But he should be good to go.
Yeah, it looks like he is. The trainer ran across to check him out.
Yeah, she's getting a lot of running in. She might just need to stay on this side.
Second down. Copper drugged down from behind. And Coulter Oldham with the stop, I think. Is that Coulter?
Can't see.
No, that's Eli Bemis.
Yeah.
Eli Bemis running him down from behind. So that's going to be third and about 16. I'll update our down and distance. I was watching the action on the sideline. Do you think eventually, Jared, it's going to be trainers at all high schools someday?
I think it's going to have to be because it'd be a lot easier for families because they wouldn't have to go to a medical provider every time.
Copper throws one up.
Intercepted.
Ross Ryder with the pick.
Hey, a little chippy.
Yes, I'm glad that's all that happened there. Timmy Johnson tipped that pass, and
yeah,
Ross Ryder right there for it.
Tip drill. That's what they're screaming down here. I think that was Coulter that tipped it.
Was it Coulter? Okay.
I think so.
And that could be. Hey, doesn't matter. It's first and 10, Lake.
Yep, 100%.
Defense is definitely stepping up. Now the offense has got to answer here. So first and 10, Bronx just outside their 45-yard line. 1:54 to go in the third quarter. Bronx on top.
But, yeah, I think trainers are probably going to become a lot more popular, but I guess it's just you got to find the people to come out here for that just because they're doing traveling, so it's not every game.
Oldham up the middle. I'll tell you what, he almost broke that.
That was close.
The defender, I'm trying to catch a number there. He held on, and that was Trace Copper. I'm going to say that's enough for a first down, and the official agreed with me.
Yep.
That won't happen very often.
Not usually.
Well, they don't have to agree with me, but sometimes I don't always agree with them.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's usually flipped around there.
We were on the same page. We were on the same page there. First and 10, Bronx. In Cimarron territory at their 44. Tight formation. Maddox under center. The give is to Oldham. Dances off the left side. Going to gain about 7. And I really shouldn't say dances, but when he hits that hole on the left side, it's just like a slide step. He just glides over. So a gain of 7 on the play brings up second and 3. From the Blue Jay 37-yard line. Once again, Brett and Jared with you. Thanks for joining us here tonight for Bronx football.
Yep.
Salcedo went in motion. And Cimarron jumped across.
Very disciplined right there.
So first and 10 Bronx now from the Cimarron 32-yard line. How many times do we see that play? You almost wouldn't think that it would work that many times, but man, it always seems to work in the right spot for the Bronx.
Yeah, like I said, very well disciplined team there to not create any movement and just let the defense be the ones to dictate that.
Bronx split a receiver wide to the right side. Beltran under center. The give is to Oldham. Nothing doing that time on the right side, brought down by Alex Lessner. And that's probably going to do it for our third quarter as we're under 10 seconds remaining. And I didn't even have the quarter set up, and now I do. So at the end of the third quarter, the Bronx still in front by the score of 28-12. Our third quarter brought to you by the good folks at Shorty's Cafe. Great homemade authentic Mexican food. My favorite, the Cory Burger. Of course, the Tort Burger is great as well. The Meisel Fries. And I'll tell you what, it's a non-menu item, but Jared, you remember the hot dog burritos? And Jared's not paying attention to me, but Jared, real quick, we're talking about
Shorty's. Yeah, what about that hot dog burrito? Sorry, I was asking some questions.
Well, that's fine. You can stay down there. But I was talking about our third quarter sponsor, Big E, at Shorty's. But they're a great menu with the Cory Burger, the Tor Burger. But a non-menu item was those hot dog burritos. And you wouldn't think that'd be that great, but, man, that was awesome.
Oh, HD burritos. Oh, you got to love them. Green chili, refried bean. Oh, man.
Oh, that
can't
was
go
great.
Wrong.
Oh, I know it. I know it.
And it's the ballpark Frank's, too. It ain't no measly little hot dog. It's the good ones.
Our fourth quarter brought to you by the KCB Bank. We'll get them here in just a minute. We got a little carried away there. So,
there's that. And then he's also done for me for my birthday one year, hot dog and alphabets. That was a strange one to me, but it was good as well.
Oh, the
hot dog and the alphabet soup.
Oh, alphabet soup.
Well, it wasn't like minus the soup part, but it was
you're talking the old Chef Boyardee alphabet.
Yep. Yeah, the alphabet and a.
Armando Salcedo sprints it off the right side up the
in.
Field. He should be in. Touchdown.
Yep.
And it is. And we've got a penalty late. Armando Salcedo with the 32-yard touchdown run for the Bronx.
I think it's going to be on Cimarron.
I would think, because I didn't see a whole lot of blue, purple shirts in that area.
Yeah, the area, because they were all over here by the pylon.
Yeah, Lakin was celebrating. So I'm going to say the touchdown is good. Yep. Okay.
There we go.
Great run, and I'll tell you what, a great block out in front to spring Salcedo. And we saw a gear that Armando's got, and we got to see it that time as soon as he got through the hole.
Yeah, we've been seeing a lot of those extra gears tonight, and it's exactly what the Bronx need.
So the Bronx will line up and go for two. Score at the end of the third quarter, Holcomb 55, Goodland 0. Wow. So the Bronx line up for two. Maddox from the gun. Now a direct snap to Oldham. He'll give it up to Patterson. Floats
Lock
it in
one
end
over.
Zone.
Oh.
Just
there we go.
Head, and we've got a late flag. Wow. Oh,
he got thrown all the way out on the track.
Wow. I mean, Drew Patterson was out in lane number three.
No, that was Maddox.
Was out in lane number three. And there's a flag on the backside, so I don't know if that's meant for the play over here.
It's a late hit.
But there was a flag. Oh, it's laying on the R in the end zone over on the other side. So we've got two flags on the play. Holy cow.
He said something about an offensive pass interference?
Huh. But, yeah, I wish I could have seen that play. And I
He said something about his receiver blocking down the field right off the start.
Okay, we'll see what we got.
Yeah.
We'll retry. Yeah. And that is really sad because a personal foul, personal foul gets negated for something like that.
Yeah.
Because I'll tell you what, you don't need to be hitting somebody clear out on the track.
Out to like lane four and five.
Boy, I know.
And he was just laid out. He's taking. But he sure got some toughness in him.
Exactly. So after it all, we will retry the point. Tell you what, we've seen some weird calls tonight. You know, just the weird call combinations.
Yeah.
On the penalties. Give us to Oldham.
And he's in.
And he's in off the left side.
And now we'll have the enforced 15-yard on this as well.
Exactly. So the Bronx will kick off from the Cimarron 45-yard line. But so with 11:49 to play in our fourth quarter, it's Lakin now 36-12. Hey, Jared, ask him. I saw who you're talking to. Ask him what he thought about his prediction the other day. Now what's he thinking?
His prediction the other day?
Yeah, Mike told me a prediction. Now ask him what he's thinking about that. See what he tells you.
He said that he changed his mind automatically. He said that he was nervous, but yeah, he said a definite mind change.
Oh, I'll tell you what. Never a dull moment with Big Mike.
Oh, never.
I'll tell you what, one of the biggest fans Laker can have, and I'll tell you what, he gets into it. He's got his predictions. He's on top of it. So the Bronx set to kick it off. Copper and Mendez standing just inside their 5-yard line. Bronx kicking off from the Cimarron 45. And that's a touchback. Was that good? It was good.
I think it might have been. Well, I was looking at my phone.
The Cimarron cameras kids back there, they held their arms up that it was good. So, wow. It's too bad Armando can't take a 5-yard run at a field goal. He's got enough for a 55-yarder there.
Yeah, no kidding.
So first and 10, Cimarron from their 20-yard line. 11:49 remaining in our fourth quarter. Bronx on top, 36-12. Bronx have scored 30 straight since Cimarron had a 12-6 lead. Copper from the gun, three receivers to the near side. Now he'll tuck it and go.
And here comes a late hit.
And the lead hit out of bounds that time.
One of the players on the sideline got laid out. Oh, and it was Braden Hansel.
But was he on the sideline or was he on the field?
No, he was on the sideline and got smoked.
Was he? I was thinking he was on the field because I heard the student section chanting Braden.
Maybe he was. I don't know.
Before that play.
It looked like he just got hit from the sideline.
Yeah.
I didn't catch it.
Oh, my clock's still running, so I got to reset it back
up. He got through to the track as well.
Late hit out of bounds on the Bronx. Well, I guarantee you that wasn't near as bad as the hit Maddox took. At least he stayed in the purple area on the sideline.
Yeah, no, he was just chilling on the sidelines, not paying attention.
Okay.
Got a nice little trip to the track. But, man, he took a wild hit the last home game we had, too. He's just getting beat up.
Well, that hit, though, he got that because he made a tackle.
Yeah. I'd say that one was a lot better, though.
Bronx threatening blitz. Copper.
Uh-oh.
Low snap.
It looked like it got caught up on the center.
And he still got through it all and out across midfield and has a first down at the Bronx 39-yard line.
Yeah, he just kind of flipped that one up.
So the Bronx getting a break there.
Maddox with a limp again.
Maddox is hobbled.
Man. I think they're going to pull him off.
No.
Well, he was signaling for it, but I don't think they're going to have enough time to do it.
I think they need to. Honestly.
With it being this score right now, yeah, pull him off of defense for right now.
I mean, I would get him off of there just to give him a breather. But we've had some extracurricular stuff going on in the field, and you can't afford that.
Yeah, exactly.
Copper pass over the middle, falls incomplete. Oh, and a late flag comes in, but Bronx player is down.
Yeah.
I don't know if maybe they got their feet tangled
up.
I
think they just kind of tripped each other up.
But that's probably going to be an pass interference on Lakin, which is unfortunate with the Bronx player down. And usually if it's a feet tangle, it's not an interference call. But
They'll probably discuss it too.
So they're going to send the teams to the sideline while they check out the injured player. Our fourth quarter brought to you by the KCB Bank of Lakin and Garden City.
Rural communities are known for their unequaled support of their hometown sports teams. KCB Bank can help you take it to the next level. We now offer Hometown School Pride debit cards, and these cards feature your hometown team mascot so you can show your pride each time you buy something. The best part, they're made right here on site, so there's no waiting for one to come in the mail. Get in touch with us right now and let us help you show your hometown pride. KCB Bank, with 3 locations, Garden City, Lakin, and on the web under your favorite search engine. Member FDIC.
Stop into the KCB Bank, Main Street, Lakin, and pick up your Lakin Bronx debit card. And they can print it. They can activate it while you wait. I haven't done it yet. I keep telling myself I need to, but I will eventually. But got to have one. Why not have one? They still are tending to the player down at the around the Lakin 28-yard line. The penalty was pass interference against Lakin, so Cimarron will have first and 10 from the Bronx 25-yard line. But right now, none of that matters as they tend to the player that's down. And he's up. That's good to see. Anytime you see a player go down and not moving immediately, that is good to see. But
I don't know. Maybe a tweaked ankle or something. Yeah, a little. That's kind of what it looked like, because he was just kind of moving it back and forth just to make sure he's got the mobility.
A little limp, but, hey, I'll tell you what, walking off on his own power, and that's Jeremy Orpiza. So good to see him back on his feet.
And we got Maddox out on this drive as well.
Well, like I said, Maddox been kind of hobbled a little bit, and So first and 10, Cimarron from the Bronx 25-yard line. Copper throws to the end zone. Incomplete. Just over the outstretched fingertips, but Ross Ryder with the coverage as well. So second down and 10 for the Blue Jays.
Looks like she might be checking knee, too, just to make sure nothing there. Looks like he's in a little bit of pain, though.
Yeah. Well, the thing about it is, I mean, for one, she's going to do everything that she knows to check. But you know what? While you're out, check it all.
Yeah, might as well.
Yeah, exactly. So second and 10, Copper from the gun. Three receivers split to the right side. Oh, a hold. I could see it in the flag. You knew was coming. Copper off the right side, and it is going to come back. The official that time didn't even have to throw it. He just kind of underhand tossed it because that was obvious.
Yeah.
So holding on Cimarron, that'll bring up a second and 20 for the Blue Jays from the Bronx 35-yard line. I don't see a lot of holds from this far up, but that one was pretty obvious. I mean, he turned him completely around.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I think they're going to say that player down here is out with possible knee.
Well, I know they're looking at Jeremy and they're going to do everything they can, but so second and 20 for the Blue Jays. Tied in the backfield with Copper. Just got rid of it. Swing pass to the right side. Kite gets to the Bronx 31-yard line. Copper was double teamed. Javion Granado in on the play. I didn't see the other defender, but he got sandwiched just as he got rid of it. Going to be third and 17 for the Blue Jays. From just inside the Bronx 32-yard line. Jeremy Orpiza jogging up and down the sideline.
It's a good sight to see. Halfback pass.
Halfback pass. It is underthrown.
Oh.
And knocked down. And I'll tell you what, I don't see the number. That was Holden Kite. That ball actually hit him.
Yeah.
Bronx had three defenders down there. That ball actually got to him. But they were able to knock it to the ground. Man, that would have been a huge catch for Kite. And he's had a good game for the Blue Jays tonight. 65-yard kick return. That would have been huge. Now it's a fourth and 17. And with the field position and being down by 24, Blue Jays obviously will go for it. 9:46 remaining. Copper with three receivers to the left side.
Man.
A wobbler.
Caught it.
And the pass is caught.
He might be down, too. Oh. I think he might have caught the ball to the gut when he came down.
So a big fourth and 17 conversion for the Blue Jays. Now they have it first and 10 from the Bronx 12-yard line.
Man, Maddox was so close to getting a hand in on that one. Just missed it.
Copper rolls out, and that one's wide of the end zone. Second and 10. So Second and 10, Blue Jays. Copper with all time to throw. Now will roll to the right side, and it's a sprint to the pylon.
Yeah, got the
And
reach.
He's in there. Trace Copper with the 12-yard run.
Thought Ross might have got to him, but just a little short behind. Maddox is down. Cramp, I think.
So another timeout on the field. Nine-11 to go in the fourth quarter. Cimarron awaiting their two-point conversion. Holcomb a final at Goodland, winning 55-14. Goodland goes to 1-3. Holcomb stays perfect at 4-0. No, wait. No, they're 3-1 because they lost to Liberal in the opener. So,
man, I wish our game had zeros on the clock.
Yeah, we're a long way from it.
Yeah, this game's taking a while.
Yep. And then with all this stuff I got up here, it's going to take me another hour to tear it down and haul it home.
Yeah.
Wish I had a cabinet I could just leave it in, but I got to have it to go to Heights next week.
Yeah, I was going
to
say, not back-to-back, so.
And speaking of Heights, Lakin will be on the road next week, traveling to Southwestern Heights for a High Plains League matchup with the Mustangs, the battle for the Golden Saddle. And, of course, we'll have the action for you right here on Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube. Pre-game at 6:30. Kickoff at 7 o'clock. Trainer and the Bronx coaches still tending to the player down. Thank everybody for joining us here tonight. I want to thank our camera girl, Allie Mead. Stepping in, always does a great job, has always done a lot of good things for us here with Lakin Sports, Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube. And Maddox back on his feet.
Walk a little stiff-legged.
Yeah, hopefully it's just a cramp. I couldn't tell how they were working on him, but it didn't look like they were stretching him out. But
they were stretching.
Were they? Okay. I couldn't see through the group of people around him. And, oh, yeah, you could tell it kind of.
Well. I'm right here, so I had the eye on it.
Okay. Yep, and he's holding it in the air, so, yeah, that looks like, yep. Glad to see that. When he comes up straight-legged like that, I was always worried. So, yeah, I'm glad he's got the leg up in the air being stretched.
Yeah, that's all they were doing down
there. That's
the
best-case scenario of anything. So Cimarron will line up and go for two. 9-11 to go in our contest. Blue Jays trying to get it back to a two-score game if they can convert. And they line up with the swinging gate. Snap to Copper.
For it.
And he'll slide in with the two-point conversion. Trace Copper with the two-point conversion. And now it's 36-20. Bronx still on top with 9-11 to play in the ballgame. Fourth quarter brought to you by the KCB Bank, Lakin and Garden City. Been one of the great sponsors that has been with Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube, lakinsports.com from the outset. now in our 17th year of bringing you Lakin High School sports. Let's see. What else can we talk about, Jared? I about talked myself out. There's still a lot of ball game to go.
Oh, man.
I need to try to talk over the music so I don't get in trouble.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm trying to do, try to talk loud whenever the music's going.
Yeah, I know.
But I guess, man, we got two Bronx out of the game right now, which hopefully that's not going to be a factor, but.
Yeah. Squib kick.
Squib. We're on it.
Timmy Johnson falls on it.
Good thing the other Lakin guy jumped on top.
That was Javion Granado to just cover him up.
Yep, smart play.
Oh, shoot. I'm getting hammered on the text message now, so.
What for?
I said I was out of things to say and said, out-talk yourself? Never. Not possible.
Yeah, no kidding.
Oh, and you agree.
Oh, yeah, always.
First and 10 Bronx from their 40-yard line.
And we'll have Drew in there as well to take the snap for the Bronx.
Drew Patterson now in at quarterback for the Bronx. And, you know, it's still a two-score ball game, but I'm not going to – of course, Maddox is just stretching out a cramp, but I'll tell you what, he is he's been battling tonight.
Yeah.
Gain of six on the play brings up second down and four.
Hey, I'm going to take a quick break, so I'll let you know whenever I come back.
Okie doke. Second and four from the Bronx 44-yard line. Stick around after the game. Hopefully, I think you'll be able to see the fireworks on the screen. But there will be some post-game fireworks. Fumble on the exchange, recovered by Lakin. And Lakin has had some trouble with that tonight. So it will be a loss back to the 45-yard line. So third down and five for the Bronx. 8 minutes to play. Bronx bring two receivers to the near side. Salcido in motion. And he's got a lane across the 40. Oh, he's going to win the foot race into the end zone. Touchdown. But we've got a flag back at the 40. Been one of those nights. Every time the Bronx have a big play, it seems to be brought back. My goodness. Illegal block in the back. And of course, I don't have replay capability, but that's one of those plays I'd like to see.
You definitely do. You just don't know how to work it.
Well, I know, but I've got some. Right now, looking at my YouTube monitor, it's replaying the homecoming festivities. But we're out on YouTube, so I'm not worrying about it.
Yeah.
But it's.
You just have yours all the way at the beginning.
Yeah, it's. And I'm not even going to mess with it.
don't touch buttons.
No,
please.
I'm not touching buttons.
I don't want to. Errors.
The Bronx will get the first and 10, but the penalty called back a long touchdown run by Armando Salcido. Drew Patterson in. No, Maddox is back
Maddox
in
is
at
back.
Quarterback. Oldham off the left side, brought down by Trace Copper. He will have enough for the first down at the Cimarron 38-yard line.
Got a nice breeze down here now.
Yeah, yeah, I still can't feel it. I'm just going to have to bring me a saw and just cut a hole in the wall just so it just goes through.
Yeah. We'll put you a block on that side of the window so it hits and falls in.
Give to Oldham. And a penalty flag. We know what that'll be.
Yep.
Only because that's been the call all night long. In that position, it's a hold right in the middle of the line. So holding on the Bronx. It will remain first down. 6:52 to go. Bronx on top, 36-20. 10-yard penalty. I don't know if it's from the, okay, they're going to, see, it was actually a couple yards downfield on that one. Oh, let's see. Let's see, five. Nope, it was from the line of scrimmage. So first and 20 for the Bronx. From the Blue Jay 49-yard line, receiver split both sides. Maddox back in under center. Fake to Oldham. Out to Salcedo near side.
Smart pitch choice there.
Timely pitch that time by Maddox. That'll bring up second and about 11. Didn't quite get back to the original line of scrimmage. Another reason our game has gone so long, Jared, we've had a lot of out-of-bounds plays, just like that one.
Uh-oh, Big Mike's nervous again. I told him man, nothing to be nervous about on this one.
Oldham gets free. He's across the 10, 5.
And he's in.
And falls into the end zone. Got it, touchdown. Colton Oldham, a 39-yard run.
I don't think he's nervous anymore.
Changed his mind again.
Yeah. He also wanted me to tell you that he's enjoying the fireworks. He says it's a good addition for homecoming. Now let's just keep this game rolling so we can get to the finale.
Yeah, well, the fireworks, it's been fun. I mean, that's what it's all about.
That's a good addition.
Having fun here. And I know at the end, as soon as we're done, you're going to go join in.
Yeah, I'll go try to get everything going quickly as we can.
Okay. Maybe we can time it just right. By the time the fireworks are done, you can come back and hand it to Coach. And we'll just do it from the field like we did last time. I think that worked great.
Yeah, that was good.
Maddox the pass.
Catch,
got it.
I was going to say it was close. He was turned away from me, so I couldn't see.
Complete to Jeremy Orpiza. No, that was Jamie Granado.
Yeah, I was going to say Jeremy's still on the sideline.
Jeremy's on the sideline. My bad. Granado with the pass from Maddox. And just like that, the Bronx back up by 24. They lead it 44-20 with 6:13 remaining. Armando Salcido set to kick off for the Bronx. Copper and David Mendez back deep for the Blue Jays inside their 10-yard line. 6:13 remaining. Bronx extending their lead back to 24 points. Ball bouncing around.
That was a nice little squib there.
And the Bronx with a gang tackle on the far side.
Put him about the 37.
So it'll be first and 10, Cimarron from there. It looks like about the 40, maybe 39. Let's see. From the 39.
Yep, 39.
Well, one thing about it, Jared, it has been an entertaining homecoming game.
Yeah, 100%.
A lot better than 2-0 last year.
Yeah, way better. This is going to be a lot nice for the Bronx. It's always great to get that win on homecoming to finish off the great week.
Yep. A lot of movement pre-snap. Copper with the snap. Pass out to the right side. Kite with it. Is wrapped up. Jayton Hash, I believe, was out there. Colder Oldham out there as well. And that might have been Eli Bemis. I'm not sure. Just really can't tell with these numbers on those purple jerseys. Second down and 5. Blue Jays go quick. And the pass is picked off.
Well, that's going to be a nice way to wrap this one out.
Who came up with it?
Can't see. Can't see who that was.
I'm wondering if it wasn't Blair Jones informatics, but I can't really tell. No, Alex Robles, number 5.
Okay, yeah.
Alex Robles with the interception, and our clock continued to run. So run it back up to 5:31 to go in our ball game. First and 10, Bronx. Salcido rolling to the near side.
Had a very nice stiff arm there.
Going to be tackled for a loss on the play. More importantly, the clock is running at 5:12 remaining.
Yeah, let's keep the ball on the ground.
It'll be a loss of 1 on the play. Second and 11 from the Lakin 22. Our fourth quarter brought to you by the KCB Bank, Lakin and Garden City. Our post-game thoughts and recap will be coming up at the conclusion of our ball game. Then we'll have our interview with the coach. And then our player of the game brought to you by Debock Metals.
Got a timeout.
And a timeout on the field. And a timeout called by the Bronx. 4:37 remaining. Lakin can hold on here. We'll improve to 3-1 before a road trip next week to Southwestern Heights. Lakin High School Band under the direction of Mr. Kalen Anderson. And the student section still rowdy. Cheerleaders leading the crowd on the track.
Yeah, when you get over in front of that student section, they're pretty loud.
Tell you what, Lakin doesn't lack for atmosphere on game day, does it?
No.
Tell you what, we've had a lot of players with big plays tonight. I don't know what we're going to do about player of the game.
Yeah, I don't even have a name in mind. This one might be all on you.
Well, the thing about it is I try not to give it to duplicates.
Yeah.
You know? But I don't know. I've got a couple names away from some that we've given it to already, so I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah, you'll have to make the decision on that.
Give up the middle.
Because I won't be able to talk to you much after the game, so it's going to come down to you.
Let's see, who was that? That was Maddox taking it up the middle. Gain of 8 and bring up 3rd and about 3 for the Bronx. First down here could almost maybe seal this thing, or maybe Cimarron wouldn't try to call timeouts and things like that.
I would hope not.
I love what we're doing, but I'm ready to go.
Yeah. I'm ready to go sit down.
Bronx with a tight formation, 3rd down and 3. Give us to Oldham.
We got a flag.
And a flag on the play. He's going to be short of the first down.
Well, hopefully it's in our favor.
Where was it thrown?
To kind of right there, right where the tackle was.
Well, that's a hold up the middle. Holding Lincoln.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, you hate to try to assume what a penalty is, but anytime it's usually in the middle.
Yeah, you know
that's
exactly
a hold.
What it is.
Unfortunately, it's been against Lincoln a lot. But, well, it is what it is. I'm not by any means up here complaining about that, but I'll tell you what, that's something I'll guarantee you that they probably want to.
Yeah, that might be talked about in practice this week.
Yeah. The 10-yard penalty will. And Cimarron does call the timeout.
Can't catch a break.
So they're going to say that penalty was downfield. Well,
Yeah, that'd be about right.
It was a little bit downfield. This is going to be 3rd and 11 instead of 3rd and 13. Once again, I want to thank the camera girl tonight, Allie Mead. And she's going to film our post game and the post game fireworks as well. So
band sounds pretty good tonight.
Yeah, they do.
Got a lot of volume.
Timeouts remaining. Lakin with 2, Cimarron with 1. 3:44 to go in the ball game.
Ball fumbled.
Wow, there was a lot of movement up front for that not to be.
The ball was snapped. It's just no one moved. So. I wonder if it was just kind of a broken play there, kind of confused on the count.
Cimarron with their 3rd and final timeout. Yeah, that was weird. I mean, there was a lot of movement, but football was bobbled. Really no movement with the football. So. Cimarron out of timeouts. It will be 4th and 11 for the Bronx.
Yeah.
Ross Ryder back to punt for the Bronx. Trace Copper back to return for Cimarron, standing at his own 40-yard line. End over end kick. Copper bobbles it on the, and I'll tell you what, credit Coulter Oldham.
Yeah, just jumping over.
Oh, everything in the world. And honestly, so many times you may not get that called when they kind of just, you know, tackle the guy. But in high school football, you never have to do it when they're on the ground.
Yep.
Yeah, so I'll tell you what, credit Coulter Oldham that time. Very wisely let that play go. Now I'll rewind our clock to 3:27. First and 10, Blue Jays.
Man, we got quads out here.
Yeah. Five receivers will be in the pattern.
Yeah, we're going to go swinging.
Receiver screen out to the near side.
There's, it's coming back.
Kite across the 40. Pushed out of bounds by Timmy Johnson. And that play coming back. You could see that push in the back.
Yeah, that was pretty obvious.
Yeah. Tell you what, I mean, I was making the comment about Lakin's big plays coming back. Cimarron's had a few too. There's been a lot of plays brought back because of penalty here tonight.
I was assuming that the screen was coming there, loading one side with receivers.
I'm still getting hammered on the text.
Better you than me.
Yeah. Tyler showing no respect.
Oh,
Copper
so close.
Evades the defender. Oh, just floats it across. Kite with it across the 40. He'll have enough for the Cimarron first down. Down to the Bronx 35-yard line. I'll tell you what, one of those plays. Copper just got the pass off, just floated it over the hands of the defender. Wow, I'll tell you what, Javian Granato just got back on sides.
I'll say if Blair had just about four more inches on him, he could have jumped and maybe tipped that one, but just enough of the float.
Norian Cantu in on the stop along, I believe, Jayton Hash out there on the stop as well. Clock continues to run. I'll run it down to 2:40. Copper rolls, unloads to the right side. Eli Bemis got a shot in on the quarterback and right there to pick him up. So I'll update our down and distance. It's third and about three for the Blue Jays. 2:32 to go. Yep, get to see Tyler here tomorrow. That'll be fun. Copper weaving his way through traffic. Ran into one of his blockers. And in on the stop, trying to catch a number. That was Norian Cantu once again. So gain of two on the play brings up fourth and one for the Blue Jays as the clock continues to run at 2:12.
Hopefully we get to see a victory formation here.
Copper fires.
Broken up.
Broken up by Coulter Oldham. And the Bronx will take over on downs.
Yeah, let's victory this and let's put a wrap on
Cimarron out of timeouts, but the Bronx can't, I mean, yeah, they could go victory at two.
Oh, easy.
I think they can, yeah.
Should be able to at least. Might have to run the first one and then maybe from there.
So, Tyler, what was the score of your game? I know you're watching this because you wanted to pick on me. So that was Atwood. You see Hill City at Atwood. So first and 10 Bronx, 2:03 remaining, and the Bronx are going victory formation. Bronx are going to improve to 3-1 as Cimarron remains winless at 0-4. Maddox takes the knee.
Guess I'll make sure we got everything set up down here and we'll get ready to rock and roll.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Are you? Yeah, I see you down at the corner. So, yeah, go ahead and do what you need to do down there. And like I said, hopefully we can time it just right that we'll get back for the coach's interview.
Perfect.
And the Bronx are just going to let the clock run down, and I think they'll call a timeout. And then well, there's no way they're going to get this off at 3 seconds breaking the huddle, and there's the timeout.
Yeah, I was going to say a little tardy on that one.
Yeah, just a little bit late. I know they're a bit milking the clock. But so the Bronx with their second timeout, 1:18 to play. Jared still with us a little bit. I'll tell you what, I love this transmitter. It reaches out.
I'm all the way in the sixth lane on the
Okay, you're about to drop out now.
No, I'm good.
Oh, okay, there you go.
I just had to turn.
No, okay.
Yeah, I'm in the sixth lane out here, so not too bad.
One 18 to go. I want to thank Allie Mead once again on our camera tonight.
Man, I might be able to just keep talking with you out here. I'm standing here by the fireworks.
Everything set up?
Yep.
All right.
We are good to go.
Sweet. Bronx with the snap. Take the knee. And it will be 3rd and 12. Clock at 36 seconds to go, 3 seconds, and that's going to do it. The Bronx take a knee, and with that, this game will end. 24 seconds, 23. Bronx are going to improve to 3-1 on the season with a 44-20 win over the Cimarron Blue Jays. And let the fireworks begin. And thank everybody for joining us. Sit back. Hopefully you'll be able to watch the fireworks on our screen. Oh man, that one blew up on the ground. I hope everybody's okay. There we go.
Oh man, my ears are ringing on that one.
I bet. Here we go.
Oh, and that wasn't even me. Oh, that one blew up too.
Well, stay clear of it. And I guess they got the proper song going off during this fireworks show. I want to thank Levi Perez and all of his help for firing these off for us tonight. A fitting end to a homecoming victory. The Bronx once again downing Cimarron by the score of 44-20. Watching down there, I don't know if that's going to be all of it, but I think I saw a couple that didn't even go off, so I don't know, we'll just have to investigate and see what happened there. But
we are good to go. We had one big one. It shot off one, and that was it. So
that yellow one?
Yeah.
And that was the coolest one.
Yeah, it shot one and then didn't go off, so.
Okay, that's okay. Oh. Are we done?
Happened. Yeah, that should be it.
All right.
It's yellow one to go again. We're trying to light again just to see.
Okay, well, if you can't, don't take a chance. But
well, it's not me. So.
I know.
I can't hear after that other one. Oh, my God. That was the loudest one, too.
All right. Well, hey, thank the gang down there for all of that. Yeah, I appreciate it. That was cool. Everybody hung around and enjoyed it. So
yeah, I heard the screams and the cheers. So that's all that matters.
All right. Well, thanks for helping out with that, and we'll wait for Coach, and then
we'll wrap it up and call it a night, eh?
Yeah, sounds good. And when you get down in range, you might wave at Allie just so she can see you, but...
Okay, I'm at the end zone right now.
Yep, I see you.
Oh, man. I wish I would have had both of the ear covers on, but I only had one side.
So, huddle is done in the end zone. So, you know, kind of timed it about right, Jared.
Yeah, it was about perfect.
Okay, and...
Is she still up there?
I believe so.
So I don't know if the camera's pointing down. Or I can't see up in there.
Okay, it's pointed to the crowd. So if you could bring Coach out to about the 25, whether we zoom in or not, he'll be on camera.
25 down here?
About the 25, yeah. And that would put you about the middle of the camera.
Okay. You tell me where.
Yeah, about right in there. You'd be fine.
About right here?
Yeah, right in there.
All right, perfect. Well, it's going to suck again because I'm not going to be able to hear the questions you're asking, but I'll just awkwardly stand down here. Actually, I might hand it to Coach and then come up and get the medal so I can bring it down to him.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I do need to do that, too. Yes. So, yeah, that'd be fine.
And I guess here we go. We got him right here.
I've got to dig him out anyway, so... All right.
Go ahead and grab the medal.
Good to go. All right, and now down on the field after all of the post-game excitement, now we're joined by Bronc head coach Chris Bamberger. And Coach, congratulations on a bounce-back win and a great night to great way to finish off homecoming night.
Yeah, gosh, can you ask for it any more? I mean, we come out and I felt like we started well. We spotted them a little bit early, but the kids hung in there and fought. And you know what? I think I told you earlier, however it goes, if we finish with more points, that's the goal, and they did, and I'm proud of them for that.
Exactly. And it got off to a great start, but I'll tell you what, one of the things that really hampered this game, and really was both sides, a lot of penalties that really slowed down, a lot of big plays that were brought back by penalties. But if there's anything to mar the game, I think it would have been that.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't matter how we feel about the calls, right? They always have the authority.
Yes.
They're gonna we're going to have to adjust. And I think we, you know, we were able to look at a lot of them, and we got a lot of things to fix, you know, as far as the holding things go. But they kept fighting, they kept snapping the ball again and kept going at it, and so I'm thankful.
Big plays were the key to the Bronx tonight, but I'll tell you what, we talked about how the defense set up the offense last week, and I really think the defense did that as well. Trace Copper did get some yards, and he was able to break free, but there again, maybe some penalties brought him back. But I thought Lakin contained him pretty well, but I thought the defense did a great job of getting the ball back to the offense.
Yeah, I think there was some times where our backs were against the wall at times. We were in a little bit of trouble, and I think the defense come out and stood up, and that's all we ask of them, fly around and tackle them. And they did that enough that we could get the ball back, and we had some good sustained drives offensively. I felt like even with the penalties, we were able to put several plays within a drive, and that was huge for us to continue to hold on to the ball and finish the game.
And on defense, of course, Copper likes to throw from the gun, throws a lot of passes, but the defensive backs, I thought, did a great job, again, shadowing defenders. Had a couple times they had maybe some possible interceptions, but the main thing, you just always at least knock it down. But defensive backs really played well in coverage tonight, too.
They did, and you know what? We had to move a lot of guys around back there. I know Maddox had to fight through a lot of stuff. I'm super proud of him. You know, that kid is tough as nails, and he keeps coming back. But, you know, when we had him on the sideline, Jeremy was on the sideline, and we had some guys that had to come in and give us some good minutes. I know Thomas Peters came in and gave us some good minutes on the offensive line. And Alex Robles came in. He got a pick.
He
played really well on the back end. And obviously Blair Jones stepped in and got us some valuable minutes. So, you know, those kind of situations are, you know, the kids, they come in and they get a little bit of baptism by fire. And I felt like they really come in and hung in there really well and gave us good minutes late in the game.
You know, sometimes baptism by fire is not a bad thing, because you step in, you know you've got to make the play right off the bat.
Yep, and they did. And I think there's a lot of kids around them that were coaching them up and a lot of positive things from them.
Offensively, a lot of big plays. Maddox, like you said, he got beat up quite a bit tonight, but he was able to score from long range. Coulter, same thing, long range. Armando got a chance to break a couple long ones tonight. But what I really enjoyed tonight was this team has team speed. Man, they had a second gear. Ryder on his long run on the far side showed another gear. Armando near side with his touchdown run. It just seems like they took it another step.
Yeah, and you know, we feel like those guys, if you get them a little bit of space, they do have some decent speed that hopefully we can take advantage of. And I felt like those plays, if you know, sometimes it can be missed a little bit, but the perimeter blocking was really solid. I think those are a couple good blocks on the edges and some guys getting downfield that help kind of spring them for those big ones.
And that's the thing. Those plays don't happen without big plays out on the edge, that is for sure. Bronx back on the road next week. The battle for the Golden Saddle at Southwestern Heights, but always feels good to hit the road with a big win.
Yeah, you know what? Heights always plays us tough. They are a tough, scrappy team, and you know what? Like always, you enjoy this one for a little while, and kind of like a loss, you flush it and you go to work for the next one. And so we got to start preparing for Heights.
Most importantly, a two-game winning streak over Cimarron, but with the win. Always a great finish to homecoming. Coach, once again, congratulations on the win. Always appreciate when you take the time to talk to us.
You bet. Thanks, Brett. We appreciate all you and Jared do, and thank you for that, and thanks for keeping coming back for us.
No, you're sure welcome. Have a great weekend, Coach. We'll talk to you next week.
Thank you.
That's Bronc head coach Chris Bamberger. Once again, the Bronx with the big win. And I didn't name the player of the game, and they're still talking. And the player of the game, I'm going to go Javian Granato. So give that to Javian. Jared was going to make me make the decision anyway, but I tell you what, Javian Granato was all over the field tonight.
That was going to be my suggestion. So
okay.
Good looks on that.
Yeah, we do agree on one thing then. All right, Jared, hey, before you get beat up by a bunch of kids playing football down there, what do you say we wrap this up and go home?
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Hey, appreciate all your help once again, and great job with Levi Perez and the fireworks gang. We had one that didn't go, and darn it, but that's okay. Yeah, everybody still enjoyed it all, and that's what it's all about.
Yeah, hopefully I get my hearing back here soon.
Exactly. Gosh, no kidding. So I want to thank all the great sponsors to make Lake and Bronx Sports YouTube possible, J.D. Hamm, our tech support. I mean, our just do everything here on LakenSports.com. and Lakin Bronx Sports YouTube. Sandy was here taking pictures. You'll get those put down on the LakinSports.com Facebook page. And Jared, once again, a great job on the sideline.
Yeah, let's wrap this up.
Let's wrap it up. And I also want to thank Allie Mead on our camera as well. So for everybody involved, I'm Brett Hendricks. Thanks so much for joining us here tonight. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. God bless. And we will talk to you next Friday from Southwestern Heights. Until then, take care.
Well, that wraps things up for today's Lakin High Sports Coverage. Be sure to join us for the next big Lakin High Sports Contest, brought to you by the KCB Bank of Lakin and Garden City, the agency of Lakin and Garden City, your full-line insurance agency, Lakin Hay and the Lakin Dairy for Edder Ipsema, Shelter Insurance, Glen Wechter, East Highway 50, Lakin, Flashbacks Diner, West Highway 50, Lakin, the Golden Plains Credit Union, Life with a Touch of Gold, the Lakin Recreation Commission, Lakin Drug, 610 O'Loughlin, Lakin, Shorty's Cafe, Main Street, Lakin, the Kearney County Economic Development, Ralph Goodnight, Pioneer Communications of Southwest Kansas, Hendricks Welding, Brad Hendricks, and D-Bach Metals of Lakin, Player of the Game, Metal Sponsor. Again, thanks, sponsors. Please let them know you appreciate what they do. We'll see you next time here on LakinSports.com.